The following is a production of Hometown and Home Country Radio Sports.
We've never seen a team like this before, ladies and gentlemen. After all this time, Bishop Garrigan is still golden. Bishop Garrigan has finally slain the Newell Fonda Dragon. Your Golden Bears are state champions for the second year in a row.
This place is packed, and it is going to be rocking in here tonight. Crooks taps it backwards, and we are underway. Buckle your seatbelts, everyone. In the lane, Crooks, center of the paint. Oh, a nice spin move, and she lays it in.
Oh, with her left hand, she claps her hands and says, let's go. You got to feed Audie this last 2 minutes.
Three-pointer is blocked at the buzzer, and that's it. After coming so close the past 2 years, Bishop Garrigan has finally won it all.
Video streaming on the Algona Radio YouTube channel is brought to you by Kavanaugh Auto Center. It's not just about the car, it's about the care. Algona Municipal Utilities, community owned for community benefit. Bauer Plumbing and Heating of Emmitsburg and Algona. Iowa State Bank, helping people succeed. Algona Frame and Auto Body, we meet by accident. PMC Advantage Insurance, having the advantage makes all the difference. Now, here's Sports Director Tyler Lance.
The latest chapter in a bitter top 5 West rivalry is tonight. The North Union Warriors host the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears. The Warriors off to their best start in program history. One of two undefeated teams left in the top of Iowa West. Right now, North Union 7-0 on the season and a perfect 4-0 in conference play. Bishop Garrigan, meanwhile, coming off their best win of the season, defeating Garner Hayfield Ventura 71-52 on Tuesday night. And the team feeling they're starting to round into basketball shape after an extended football season. Good evening, everyone. Tyler Lance, view on Hometown Radio, KLGA Algona, and at the Algona Radio YouTube stream is tonight. It's the next chapter in the Bishop Garrigan versus North Union developing rivalry in this conference. These two teams have split the last four matchups. The home team has won the last four, and that's good news for the North Union Warriors. They're at home tonight against the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears, but it's a new look Golden Bear team, one that graduated four of their top five scorers from last season. It's off to a 3-3 start to this season, but really nice game on Tuesday for the Golden Bears. Played really well defensively in that one especially and shot the ball extremely well. Michael Joyce was 8-12 from the field. Carter Schwab was 6-11 and Logan Nemers was 8-11 as they led the Bishop Garrigan offense in that ball game, and they got just enough stops throughout the game to really limit Garner Hayfield Ventura and keep them below their normal offensive output. Meanwhile, it's been a busy week for North Union, and that week continues tonight. Warriors played at Norfolk Kensett on Monday night, picked up the victory in that game, then had a defensive lockdown performance against Belmont Clemmie on Tuesday as they held the Broncos to under 30 points. And now it's the first of back-to-back games for North Union. They play, of course, tonight against the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears, and they will be at the Baumgars Invitational in Sioux City tomorrow. So a busy, busy week for the North Union Warriors. We'll talk about it all with both head coaches. We'll start off with Bishop Garrigan head coach Mark Meister. Then we'll talk with North Union head coach Alex Fisher. They're coming up after this message on KLGA 92.7.
When you need cash on the go, there's no need to pay a surcharge fee with MoneyPass. Iowa State Bank is proud to be part of the MoneyPass network of surcharge-free ATMs found nationwide. Look for the green and blue MoneyPass symbol on over 32,000 ATMs across the nation. Or find an ATM near your vacation spot or travel destination at MoneyPass.com. MoneyPass, another way that Iowa State Bank helps people succeed. Member FDIC.
Continuing with pregame coverage right now on Hometown Radio KLGA as we get ready for the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears and the North Union Warriors tonight as we talk to Bishop Garrigan boys coach Mark Meister. Coach, first of all, we appreciate you giving us a few minutes here on the pregame show. Let's start off with your game earlier this week against Garner Hayfield Ventura. Really good win for you guys as you beat the Cardinals 71-57 in that ball game. What were a few things you felt went right on Tuesday night?
I thought running our offense was magnificent. The ball movement, we're really working side-to-side action, switching sides of the floor and making teams rotate. And we had a concerted effort throwing the ball in the paint, and we had a lot more inside-out threes, and we've been working on that quite a bit, just kind of spreading around the ball more, knowing that some of those guys are going to score more than other guys, but getting those other players comfortable to make plays for our other guys to score, and it worked out really great that night.
And, Coach, you mentioned getting some paint touches, and a lot of that centers around Logan Nemers, of course. He had a really good game with 19 points, really did not miss too many shots throughout the course of the night. Could you speak on how Logan has developed as an inside player, just from the standpoint of getting better touch around the basket and better positioning in the post and those sort of things as he's kind of improved his game?
Well, I think you're starting to see him get in shape, number one. He's starting to move more. He's always been good at pinning and sealing guys out of the way with his great size he's got. And as that starts to increase, you know, we're able to find him more, and he's doing a great job of finishing. Even going back to the Eagle Grove game, he had a heck of a game there, and I didn't think we got him or Drew Moeller the ball enough down there. Moeller was 7-7, and I think Nimmers was 9-11 or something down there. We were trying to get it inside out down there as well, and I think we settled too much. And then next game, Garner, you know, we don't settle as much, and you see how well that inside out game works for us when you're that confident in a guy to make buckets down there. And he can kind of stretch the floor a little bit when they're trying to double team him underneath. He has gone out further and made some of those mid-range shots, so it's loosened the game up for us a lot.
And coach, for tonight's game, you guys get back to top of Iowa West plays. You travel to North Union to face the Warriors. They're obviously a good team that's gotten off to a good start to the season, of a 7-0 record. When you compare the Warrior team you've seen the past couple of years with what you've seen this year, what stands out to you?
Well, I think they've been working for this for quite a while. When these kids were, they've got a lot of seniors. These kids were freshmen. I don't remember what the record was, but it obviously wasn't what it was now, and they've just kind of stuck with it. Now it's all coming together for them, so, you know, happy for those kids that have put in time. They share the ball really well. The scoring, you know, is very even on the team. That's kind of the biggest standout to me, how well they're sharing the ball. The point guard does a really good job of distributing it, and it seems like the rest of them all play off of that. So we've got to deal with defending the Jones kid, number one, and, you know, trying to kind of cut the head off the snake and then deal with the rest of them.
Talking right now with Bishop Garrigan boys basketball coach Mark Meister. And coach, you bring up a good point about the passing ability of North Union, especially when it comes to Jones, because they're a team that has some guards who really know where to go for the basketball, and of course a lot of seniors on that team who have played together for a while, so the chemistry is there as well. When you talk about defending North Union's passing game and trying to cut that off a little bit, what are a couple factors that go into that?
Well, we're going to have to mix and match our defense, and it's going to have to happen on the fly. It can't be during timeouts or things of that nature, so we've been working on that. How we are defending certain guys, trying to make certain guys do certain things that they're not comfortable with, you know. Looks like some of them aren't as comfortable on dribble pull-ups. Some of them are very good getting the rim, and some of them are good three-point shooters. So you got to be kind of all over the board and understand if there's a switch on defense and you're on a certain guy, you need to understand the assignment. So we've been going over that quite a bit, and it's going to take a lot of talking. There's times where our defense still is not talking enough. We start out a game either really bad or really good, and we either end of that, we keep talking and we sustain it, or we don't, and then it goes haywire. So we got to work on talking, because we're a team that likes to get out and run. We've had few games in the 80s, a few games in the 70s, so, you know, we like to score the ball, and it's got to start on that end, and this is the end of the floor tonight. That's going to be very important for us to get a win.
Coach, along those same lines, what do you feel a couple of the biggest deciding factors for tonight's game will be?
Break the press clean and score on it. They pressed us some this summer. We took care of it. I've watched the press. I feel like the way they press, the way we break it, we have a couple different ways we break presses. I think if we do that well, we should be fine. Run our sets that we're having success with right now, and it's still going to come down to that defensive end of the floor. When I look at the stats, you know, the team stats, a lot of them are kind of falling in line with us. The thing is, it's the defense is key, because they have more balanced scoring than we do right now. There's, I believe, four in double figures and two kind of close to double figures. So they got six of them that are right there. So it's going to take a team-oriented defensive mindset to take care of those guys.
Coach, we appreciate the time today and wish you best of luck with tonight's game.
All right, thanks, Tyler.
Bishop Garrigan boys basketball coach Mark Meister talking on the pregame show. Right now we'll step aside for a quick timeout and get back for more next coming up on KLGA 92.7 and at the Algona Radio YouTube stream.
For over 40 years, Northwest Iowa Bone, Joint, and Sports Surgeons have maintained one mission: to provide excellence in orthopedic care. Their team of nine physicians offer specialized care in everything from arthroscopic same-day surgery to joint replacement, as well as hand and foot surgery, and have an orthopedic surgeon on call 24/7. Healthcare isn't about appointments, it's about taking care of people, and that's their specialty. Visit Northwest Iowa Bone, Joint, and Sports Surgeons on the web at nwiabone.com.
Set for boys' top of Iowa West Conference basketball action right now on Hometown Radio KLGA as the North Union Warriors host the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears. And right now we're joined by North Union head coach Alex Fisher. Coach, thank you for giving us a few minutes today.
Hey, thanks a lot, Tyler, and thanks for covering us again.
Absolutely, and Coach, it's been another good week for the Warriors as you guys defeated Northwood Kensett on Monday night, then picked up a conference win over Belmont Clemmie on Tuesday night. So let's once again start off just an overview of the week and a couple of your takeaways from those two games starting off this week.
Yeah, you know, we made a long trip over to Northwood on Monday and saw a really good Viking team over there, a group that's gotten better each year. You know, they're a group of, I think they got five juniors that start for them. They've been playing since they're freshmen. And they're a tough matchup, too. You know, they got 6'5", 6'6", and 6'4". You know, and all those guys really aren't true post players either, so they play around the perimeter. Makes it kind of hard to match up with. You know, we went down there and kind of got off to a little bit of a slow start, you know, and credit to them. You know, they're not a bad ball club down there by any means. You know, they did some nice things to us defensively that made it hard for us. But then we kind of opened up in the second half a little bit, went on a nice run in the third quarter to kind of blow it open. You know, wasn't really happy with our fourth quarter we played. We got a little sloppy and turned over late and had some poor time management. But for the most part, you know, whenever you go on the road and play a good competition, it's nice to come away with a win.
Absolutely, Coach. And then on Tuesday night, it was a really good defensive performance against Belmont Clemmie as you held them to 27 points, and they only had 14 going into the fourth quarter, so a lot of those were late once the game was out of hand. And I know we talked last time just about how good the defense has been so far and how your guys have been kind of unselfish in approaching the defense, but defensively Tuesday night against Belmont Clemmie, what was working for you against the Broncos?
Yeah, we had a little extra juice behind us because the kids kind of felt, too, that our defense wasn't up to par down there at Northwood. You know, we kind of gave up some easy stuff that we're not, you know, accustomed to doing. So we kind of wanted to come out and really kind of refocus and regroup, and that we did. You know, and you said it was 25-4 after the first quarter. You know, we kind of backed off the pressure a little bit, but in the half-court game really did a nice job the second quarter, too, and outscored them 28-6. You know, so holding the team to 10 points. You know, and Belmont's young, and they're going to be a force here in a couple of years, but, you know, we wanted to kind of show how physical we can be within the rules of the game and really make it hard for them. And, you know, we call it a no-paint touch possession, and that's what we want to do is keep the ball out of the paint. That way we don't have to force any extra closeouts or use any help. And you know, we tried track it the first half, and we really limited their paint touches. You know, it was under 10. You know, I thought we did a great job of defending in there. And then when they did get paint touch, we did a nice job of closing out and really making it hard on them. So credit to our kids for kind of getting refocused and regrouped and having a heck of a defensive performance on Tuesday night.
Talking right now with North Union basketball coach Alex Fisher. And Coach, tonight you welcome the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears to your high school gymnasium. It's been a couple really good matches the past couple of seasons when you've seen them, and both teams have kind of defended their home court the past few years. I guess overall, what are some of the big things that stand out to you about this year's Golden Bear team?
You know, they really got some talented guys on the offensive end, you know, that can hurt you in a lot of ways. You know, obviously it starts with Swab, you know, who handles the ball primarily, you know, can score from the outside, but also when he gets going downhill, he's tough to stop. You know, he's going to be a strong kid, and he sees the floor really well. You know, then you pair him with Joyce, with what a freshman year he's having. You know, he's at 18 points a game and seen some stiff competition too. So a kid who can hurt you inside, outside, off the bounce, okay, catching it. You know, he gets some post-ups, can hit some fadeaway stuff. I mean, so two guards that are really handy and can really score if you let them. You know, and then they pair it with some big guys. You know, obviously the Nimmers, big body on the block, easy to get defenders sealed, and he finds that little over his left shoulder, nice little touch. And then he's also a kid who can, you know, hit a wide-open 15-footer at a pretty high clip too. The Mueller kids brings in some size and also stretches the floor and can shoot it. You know, Lear and Thomas come off the bench, another couple bigs that make it hard on both ends of the floor. And then just their depth in general. You know, they're kind of like us where they – you know, can go eight guys deep and don't have a big fall off and do a lot of different things on both ends of the floor. So definitely going to be a challenge for us. But I think it really starts with slowing down those, you know, their top two scorers in Joyce and Schwab. And, you know, like we just talked about our defense, I think, you know, we're going to give them some different things that maybe they haven't quite seen yet, you know, as far as the abilities we have to play defense by individuals on our team and then also as a unit as a whole.
Wrapping up for today, what do you feel one or two of the biggest deciding factors in tonight's game are going to be?
it starts in that defensive end. We talked about it. You know, same thing. We're going to keep them out of the paint. We know they shoot it at a pretty decent clip. You know, I think they're shooting, you know, 33% from three. But the game starts in the paint. You know, we got to keep the ball out of the paint. Don't let the defense get broken down. You know, find doubles when we need to. But then on offense, we also need to get out and run and do what we do well. You know, and that's when we play fast. You know, it could be a high scoring game. You know, and that's very well the kind of game we can win. You know, I think that's what makes us tough is we can win games where, you know, we only score 50 and the game gets slowed down, and we can win games where we have to score 80 or 90. You know, and if tonight turns into a little bit of a track meet, our kids are ready for it. You know, getting out and going in transition, but then also, you know, we've done a better job this year too of decision making, and we've done a better job of you know, finding the open looks and taking care of the ball and not forcing it as much as we did last year. So we're going to value each possession and try to be as effective as we can on the offensive end.
Coach, we appreciate your time today, and best of luck in tonight's game.
Hey, thanks a lot, Tyler, and go Warriors.
That is North Union basketball coach Alex Fisher talking about the Warriors here on Hometown Radio KLGA. We'll step aside for a timeout and get you closer to tip-off coming up next on 92.7 FM and the Algona Radio YouTube stream.
At Security State Bank, we realize each customer has a unique set of needs and goals. That's why we place a greater value on providing outstanding customer service. All products and services are designed for customers within our local community. We value each customer that walks through our door and wants to give them the personalized attention they deserve. Find out why Security State Bank in Algona, Burt, and Laverne is your partner in community banking. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Security State Bank.
High school sports on Hometown and Home Country Radio are brought to you by these fine sports club members.
American Glass. For all your glass needs, think American.
Farm Bureau Financial Agents Dave Beisch, Jason Brace, Daniel Folk, and Michael Toth.
Kemco Tires. They're all you need to know about tires and service.
Weikert Realtors, the 515 Agency, a fresh approach to real estate.
Billy Offerman, your State Farm Insurance Agent in Algona. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Iowa Lakes Community College, your community, your college.
Lusher Family Dentistry, serving your family since 1965 on Call Street in Algona.
BMC Advantage Insurance Services, insuring our neighbors for over 80 years.
Walker Chiropractic and Wellness, caring for Algona, Sway City, and the surrounding areas with chiropractic, nutritional, and physical therapy services.
All sponsors of this game broadcast. We've got more sports club members making this broadcast possible on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Reeves Wicked Good Bar and Grill. For wicked good food, drinks, and service, you gotta go to Reeves.
CB Grain Solutions, satisfaction guaranteed.
New Way K&H Co-op, delivering exceptional value through knowledge and innovation.
Dump It, they do the dirty work so you don't have to.
Albert Electric, flip the switch to Albert Electric.
Grassmasters, growing satisfied customers.
Greg Penning and Company, certified public accountants, where everyone counts.
Yemlin Builders and Apartments, quality apartments for rent, beauty and craftsmanship that will never go out of style.
Daylight Donuts, open early with delicious donuts and great coffee.
All sponsors of this game broadcast.
For over 40 years, Northwest Iowa Bone, Joint, and Sports Surgeons have maintained one mission: to provide excellence in orthopedic care. Their team of nine physicians offer specialized care in everything from arthroscopic same-day surgery to joint replacement, as well as hand and foot surgery, and have an orthopedic surgeon on call 24/7. Healthcare isn't about appointments, it's about taking care of people, and that's their specialty. Visit Northwest Iowa Bone, Joint, and Sports Surgeons on the web at nwiabone.com.
It's time to meet the starting lineup for the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears.
Drew Muller Jr., number 23.
Outside Muller, he'll step back. Three on the way, and he sticks it.
Justin Bauer, senior, number 15.
Rises for a mid-range jumper, rolls off no good. The follow by Bauer, he put it in, he got fouled. Chance for a three-point play by Justin Bauer.
Logan Nemers, senior, number 42.
Lobs it into Nemers, on the block, takes a power dribble, puts it up and puts it in.
Carter Schwab, sophomore, number 24.
Now over to the right to Schwab, lets the free ball go, and he got it! Carter Schwab at the buzzer, drills his first three-pointer.
Michael Joyce, freshman, number 11.
And the And now play is going nowhere. Joyce picks it up to the backcourt, and he's going to flush it. Michael Joyce with the first throwdown of his high school career.
Tip-off of your game is coming up next on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
That is the Bishop Garrigan starting lineup for coaches Meister and Frelick. For North Union and reigning top of Iowa West head coach of the year, Alex Fisher, they will have the senior Preston Gaudette, senior Daniel Fothergill, senior Kyan Jones, senior Aiden Lofstrom, and senior Cody Ermeter. Tyler Lance, Beanie Bodie, if you're here on KLGA 92.7. Beanie, what a matchup tonight. What a great environment here at North Union High School. Always a great game when the Bears and the Warriors battle in boys basketball.
Boy, you're not wrong there, Tyler. There's been some fun matchups between these teams dating way back. Got a lot of seniors on North Union, got some youth on the Garrigan team, and a lot of athleticism on this floor tonight here in Armstrong.
At midcourt, the 6'5 numbers against the 6'5 Ermeter. Bishop Garrigan in their road black uniforms, the gold Bears across the front, the gold lettering and numbering on the front and back as the ball's tapped sideways. North Union takes it, and we are underway. Warriors in the home right, whites as they head left to right on the radio dial, the green numbers on the front and back, and the green Warrior logo on the front. In the lane, Fothergill stops at the foul line, pivoting and kicking it out to Jones, far side of the court. Fakes on the free as Schwab gives him a ton of space, and now North Union has a Gaudette top of the key. Back to the left side, Jones launches on a 3-point. Boom, he cans it! 3-0 North Union right off the jump.
Jones taking advantage of that home court advantage. He's comfortable with these hoops.
Bauer splits a double team and threads the pass over to Schwab. Bishop Garrigan, number three right now on the top of Iowa West, scoring in 67.3 points per game as the ball is knocked away from Nemers. Out of bounds as Bishop Garrigan will keep it along the baseline.
Right off the bat, you see the great active defense of North Union. Hands everywhere. They are athletic and have a lot of experience working together.
Warriors letting up just 45.6 points per game so far in their 7-0 start to the season. 4-0 in conference play as Bauer tries to find Mahler on the post, but the pass is out of his reach for an early turnover.
Boy, Coach Fisher said in his pregame interview, we'll see how the tempo goes. North Union, they can take it to the track meet level, but right now they're pretty methodical running their offense.
This is a gym where the fans are right on top of you, the walls are right on top of you, very small out-of-bounds area. Garrigan will have to adjust to that as Fothergill spins right, banging with Joyce, tough fadeaway jumper, no good, and Schwab snatches the rebound. Schwab, quick pass up to Bauer. Bauer sailing in, draws the foul, put it in! Chance for a three-point play by Justin Bauer.
Schwab pushing that tempo up the floor, the point guard. Justin Bauer, no problem racing down the floor. He's a trackster. Really kept his balance there. He got airborne, drew the contact, and hung in the air. Some good hang time there by the senior Bauer, sporting a knee brace on that repaired left knee he goes to the free throw line with.
Bauer averaging 5.2 points per game for the Golden Bears. Tees up the free throw and knocks it down. And we are tied at 3 apiece. 1 minute gone in quarter number one from North Union High School. Kyan Jones handles the rock and gives it off to Fothergill. Fothergill left the lane, guarded by Joyce. Kicks it out, Ermeter. Right angle free. Point ball, and he smashes it. Cody Ermeter knocks down a three, and it's 6-3 North Union.
Starting out some hot shooting for North Union, and they are pumped. Boy, both all the players are pumped.
Ermeter made one three-pointer last year. He's made three this season now as the ball is knocked away from Nemers in the post. Here comes Fothergill, gives it to Ermeter. Ermeter, another three-point try. Good again! Ermeter pumped up near half court, and North Union's up 9-3, and a timeout by Bishop Garrigan. 1 minute and 30 seconds into this one.
Wow, Tyler, talk about emotion. Carter Schwab and Justin Bauer just made the fast break, and they're flexing, they're pumped, and right back at you, Ermeter for North Union. Makes two threes, and he's flexing like he's in the weight room. There's a lot of testosterone on the floor tonight. I think these boys are ready to go, and they're just getting ready for a big weekend of basketball, both teams.
Yes, Garrigan has the crosstown game tomorrow against Algona. North Union has the Baumgars Invitational in Sioux City on Saturday. But Beanie, Ermeter had three three-pointers in his career before tonight. He has two three-pointers in the first 90 seconds of this game.
And let me tell you, they were not accidental. He swished those things.
Those are great shots by Ermeter. I'll tell you what, North Union, they really do not have too many weaknesses this year. If they could just get that three-point shooting up a little bit, they'd be nearly unbeatable. And really, they've been unbeatable so far, even though they're only shooting 26% on threes as they're 7-0. Ball knocked away from Mahler. Jones has the steal in the backcourt. Gets it to Gaudette. Foul line jumper on the way, and it rolls in. Big start by North Union, 11-3.
So, Mr. Lance, you mean to tell me they're not a three-point shooting team, but they're 3-for-3 right now?
Schwab drives in, slicing in, drawing the foul. He put it in, and a chance for an and-one. We're going so fast, Beanie, I can hardly
Holy
answer that
moly.
Question, but they have not been a great three-point shooting team this year, but they've been great so far tonight.
No kidding, 3-for-3. Schwab does what he does best. Boy, he can go downhill. Coach Fisher knows it. You get Schwab in the open court, he's got great ball handling skills, and after coming off the offensive line for Bishop Garrigan, he knows how to throw some weight around. He is a reckoning.
Schwab too strong on the free throw, and it's 11-5 North Union at the 6:05 mark of quarter number one. Schwab averaging 13.3 points a game for the Golden Bears. Jones left of the lane, deals into the corner as he finds Fothergill, and 3-second violation called against North Union.
Oh, the favorite 3-second violation. You don't see that called very often. Officials on the spot with that one.
That is the favorite call of fans to shout out from the crowd, though, I will say, on both sides, usually on a nightly basis. As Bauer looks and he underhands it to Joyce, weaving away from the full court press, jumps past the Schwab, a little bit high, but Schwab deflects it and keeps it inbounds. Left wing to Joyce, in the post, Nemers, center of the paint, outside Mahler in the right corner, Mahler back inside to Nemers, power dribble, puts it up, through contact, and he scores it.
That might be an advantage for the Bears. Logan Nemers can really power inside if they can get the ball to him.
Nemers had 19 points on 8-11 shooting against the Cardinals of Garner Hayfield Ventura on Tuesday as Gardette leaves a three-point ball short and Nemers vacuums in the rebound. Here comes Mahler on the push. Mahler turns it back outside to Schwab on the left wing. Eyes the bucket, drifts to the right by two dribbles. Now finds Bauer along the perimeter. Bauer back to the left wing. Mahler tees up a three-point ball and it's a little bit off target. Ermeter picks the rebound out of the sky.
Well, each rebound is a definite battle between these two lineups on the right now. Ermeter versus Nemers.
And we've got a whistle on a traveling violation against Garrigan. It's a little cough of the basketball at the 5:09 mark.
Kyan Jones left his feet, and he had planned a jump stop, but when he hit the ground, he did a little bit of a shuffle. Turns the ball over there. Tyler, this gym is so tight. Not any room to take the ball out of bounds across the way along the stage. And when you get the ball in the corner for a three-pointer, you better make sure your heels aren't touching.
So after the turnover by North Union, Garrigan has it. Joyce looking for the baseline. Fothergill does a nice job cutting him off. Pass back outside to Schwab. Finds the elbow, jumps and gets it away to Bauer before he lands. Now down low, Mahler. Feeds Nemers. Ball knocked away, but a foul. Fothergill got Nemers on the arm. That's an early three fouls by North Union.
Nice interior pass there from Mahler to Nemers. Garrigan moving the ball around well. If there's any thing they're trying to work on in practice, I'm sure, is keeping that offense flowing.
Bauer has the basketball on the left wing. Bauer splits down the lane, tried to bounce it to Demers, but bounce it right into the pocket of Daniel Fothergill for the turnover. Here comes Kyan Jones running the North Union offense, averaging 7 assists per game, leading the conference. A foul line jumper, and he swishes it.
He's very good at dribble drive, pulling up for that jump shot. We've been watching Kyan Jones for at least 3 years and being very skilled at that move.
The all-time leader in assists for North Union as Michael Joyce has the basketball. Joyce, a foul line jumper, right back the other way. He knocks it down.
Boy, if Kyan Jones can do it, Michael Joyce says, I can do that too. Almost the same shot.
Michael Joyce has 4 20-plus point games in the 6 Garrigan games so far this season. Golden Bears 3-3 on the season. Gardette right wing for North Union. Dribbles a couple of times, looking to flip it over to Fothergill in the corner. Fothergill lets the three-pointer fly, left it way short, and Schwab rebounds in the lane. Here comes the tempo. Schwab driving in, a sidestep, and he traveled. Schwab will turn it over as he doesn't like that one, but North Union gets it back.
Going to get some subs in the game. First breather for either team. Neither coach wants to take out their starters here, but Garrigan subs first, brings in Furch and Sink. That's Tate Furch and Trayton Sink, and North Union's going to give Ermeter a break.
North Union brings Grady Madden into the ballgame, adding some three-point shooting off the bench. He was their leading three-point shooter last season, as he's in the right corner right now. Jones walks the ball across half court. 3:52 on the clock, quarter number one, 13-9 North Union. Wallstrom looking inside. Madden was trying to post up against Furch, and an offensive foul. Fothergill looked like he was trying to get loose against Joyce, and if that's on him, that is number two, and that's actually going to be on Gardette. Also Gardette's second.
Well, I got to tell you, these officials are on the spot with their calls tonight. They came ready to play too. You know, everyone's got to get up for this game in the gym, and the officials have tonight. They're calling it real tight, real clean, not missing anything.
Drew Henderson checks into the ball game. The 5'10 sophomore enters for Preston Gardette as Bishop Garrigan has the basketball, heading right to left on the radio dial. Furch on the wing finds the cutting Mahler, edge of the paint. Mahler back to the bucket. Mahler flings it across the sink. Quick pass down to the baseline to Furch. 3:33 on the clock, and Furch throws it away. Shows the steal, and he gets clotheslined by Trayton Sink. That'll be foul number one on Garrigan.
I think Trayton Sink got caught. Boy, that foul probably prevented a run-out layup, but Trayton Sink kind of clotheslined him there along the stage. Yeah, I didn't think he... I think he couldn't make the decision whether to try to cut off that baseline or try to turn and run.
It is 13-9, North Union on top of Bishop Garrigan, 3:25 on the clock in quarter number one. Wallstrom gets it down to Fothergill. Fothergill on the baseline, hangs and passes in the corner. Henderson tees up a three, and it's off the heel, no good. Mahler tipped the rebound out, it's off his hands, but Henderson tracks down a miss near half court. Outside to Jones on the wing, guarded by Sink. Now it's Madden at the foul line. Pumps, drives in, puts up a tough shot, no good. Furch forced him wide, and now here comes Mahler. Mahler gives it off to Carter Schwab. Pull it away. Madden has the steal. Madden to the far side of the court. Pulls up for a three-point ball. It's an air ball long. Saved in the play by Fothergill, but threw it right to Sink. Sink out to Mahler, and he throws it away for a turnover.
Whoa, both these teams getting a little helter-skelter here. That ball's flying all over the place. Oh, both these teams, you could say everybody's got the green light. Everyone is looking to score that bucket tonight. And, wow, that was a little bit of the tempo that I think this could degenerate into. Boy, that was some fast basketball.
Yeah, that green light, greener than the North Union colors all throughout this gym as Jones is in the lane. Skips the pass out to Henderson on the wing. Henderson dribbles towards the top of the key, picks it up and flings it left over to Fothergill, guarded by Joyce. Here's the screen by Henderson. Fothergill to the foul line, goes up and under. Dish down to the baseline to Henderson, now back outside Jones on the wing. Jones looking, reading the defense, driving and kicking to Madden. Nine on the shot clock. Jones left corner. Now into Wostrom in the post. Outside to Henderson. Henderson wants to drive. Henderson hangs. Shot off the back of the cup, no good. And Sink snatches the rebound. It rolls away from him, though, as Henderson was trying to rip it away. And that was last touched by Sink.
Fortunate bounce there for North Union. They had used up the whole clock in that possession there. They passed up a few shots, ended up having to take that floater. But, you know, we've seen Lostrom hasn't got a lot of good looks at the bucket for his work inside yet. And number two, he's given up a couple good looks here. He's looking to pass that ball to the outside for the three-point, and why not, Tyler? They're shooting three-pointers well so far today.
Yeah, it's Daniel Fothergill, who's averaging 3.4 assists per game, one of the many good passers on this North Union team. They really dissect the defense by passing the basketball as Fothergill has it. Ball stripped away, and Carter Schwab has it. Schwab outlet up to Joyce. Joyce drives in, and that's going to be a foul on Garrigan. Sinkle's trying to create space for Joyce that time and kind of setting a de facto type of screen there.
Boy, like I said, that's a good spot by the official. Sink just trying to set a screen for Joyce, but got caught moving his feet, moving screen that prevented Joyce from getting that run out layup. But boy, that ball moved up the floor in a hurry. Fast basketball in a small gym is very fun to watch.
As Sink checks out of the game, Bauer checks in. So right now, Nemers, Schwab, Furch, Bauer, and Joyce for the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears. 2 minutes left in quarter number one, 13-9 North Union. These teams have gone into an offensive drought involving a lot of turnovers over the past couple minutes. Jones deep on the left wing, passes in the corner to Madden. Madden launches on a three, in and out, no good as Nemers grabs the rebound. Nemers had 19-9 against Garner Hafe of Ventura on Tuesday, and that 71-52 Garrigan win. Schwab passes left to Furch. In the left corner to Bauer. Looks inside for Joyce. Takes one dribble and flings it to Nemers. Just inside the foul line. Back out to Furch. Head fakes. Comes near side to Joyce. Joyce in the lane. Joyce across the paint. Flips it up to the right hand and it drops in.
Oh, just a natural score. I'd hate to play one-on-one against that guy. 13-11 is the score here. Quarter winding down.
4 points Joyce. A sidestep by Kyan Jones. And the referee from behind calls a foul. That'll be foul number three against Bishop Garrigan as Jones will head to the charity stripe for two.
You know, both coaches have been able to do a lot of substitutions in this first quarter. They're realizing the premium on not only staying fresh in this game, but like you said, Tyler, both these teams are going to play tomorrow. So both challenge for the coaching staff, keeping people fresh all night, looking for their weekend.
And both of these teams go very deep off the bench. Both are eight deep as Jones swishes on the foul shot. Checking into the ball game, Cody Ermeter for North Union as Aiden Lofstrom checks out. Free throws a big factor in the last two games at this gymnasium. Both of these past two games inside this North Union gym were won by North Union. The Warriors shot 45 and 32 free throws in those two games, so Garrigan has to find a way to stay out of foul trouble in tonight's game to stay in it. Ball pops out as Jones can't knock down the free throw. It's 14-11 Bishop Garrigan. Schwab bounce past Joyce. Corner pocket Trey, and it's an air ball. Bauer on the cleanup, and Bauer puts it in.
Nice, Johnny, on the spot. Bauer's now with 5 points on the day. That's bonus for Garrigan because Bauer's not looked for to score as much as others.
In the right corner, Drew Henderson for North Union, and Henderson will be called for the traveling violation as he tried to pass to Fothergill.
Good defense by Furch. The quarterback on the football team kind of deked him into taking a travel. He faked like he was going to reach for the ball and then kind of forced a footwork shuffle.
Carter Schwab setting things in motion for Bishop Garrigan as Joyce has it deep on the left wing. Schwab, top of the key, rotates right to Justin Bauer. Back to the top to Schwab. Bodies crash to the ground, and that'll be a foul against Garrigan. Ermeter was on the ground over there.
I saw it all, Tyler. Tate Furch came the screen down, and Ermeter tried to fight through the screen, and Tate Furch, the football player, said, I can block better than this, and he laid a football block and kept moving with it. Another moving screen by Garrigan.
Both teams have 4 fouls in the first quarter as Furch picks up his first personal foul. Nemers is on the bench right now for Bishop Garrigan. Mahler back in. 47 seconds left in the first quarter as Jones will patiently walk the ball across half court. North Union shooting 49.5% from the field this year, number two in the conference, behind Lake Mills as Grady Madden has the basketball. Madden driving in and a push from behind against Bishop Garrigan. This will put Madden at the free throw line for two.
Well, you start to see this new free throw rule come into effect in this game because at the quarter break here in 35 seconds, the fouls will reset, but five fouls and you get to shoot two. So two free throws for Madden here. But, Tyler, so that gives teams some freedom here. I think so far this season we've actually seen less free throw shot because of this rule.
I think that's very possible as well. You think about 10-2 quarters versus 5-1 quarter. Obviously, the division is the same, but you're a lot less susceptible to one bad quarter ruining the entire half.
Right, because as it is, two more fouls, and North Union will be shooting a one-on-one until halftime.
The free throw on the way is knocked down by Grady Madden. 2-for-2 at the free throw stripe, as he had been 1-of-6 coming into tonight, but knocks down a couple there to make it 16-13 in favor of North Union. Shot clock and game clock are even at 27 seconds. Joyce flings it left to Schwab. Pumps towards the corner to Furch and holds the basketball. Flips to Mahler on the wing, right back to Schwab. Schwab, three-point ball from straight on, and he rattles it in. Schwab ties the game at 16. North Union back the other way. Madden left open in the corner, and his free ball way too strong. Ermiter chases it down with 10 seconds. North Union with a second chance opportunity. Madden near side, fades back for a triple, and he buries it.
Oh, that Madden can shoot.
1 second left in the quarter. Schwab half-court heave, and that one is off the glass. No good, as Schwab cannot knock down the three-pointer at the buzzer. At the end of one, it's North Union 19 and Bishop Garrigan 16. A hard-fought game, just as promised, right here on Hometown Radio KLGA and at the Algona Radio YouTube stream.
Thank you to these sports club members bringing you this game on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Kossuth Regional Health Center, make KRHC your home for health care.
Tom Eichen Sales, your store in the country, carrying steel and Toro products and Green Mountain pellet grills.
Algona Plumbing and Heating, where a good flush always beats a full house.
Runke Brothers Full Service. Experience the Runke Brothers difference for all your auto service and repair needs.
Erpelding Boyd & Company CPAs, they're not just about taxes.
Hy-Vee, use the Fuel Saver card. Fill your cart, fuel your car.
North Iowa Appliance Center, Highway 18 East in Algona, where they sell the best and service the rest.
Erpelding Excavating Enterprises, let them take care of your grading, excavating, and drainage needs.
AK's Chrome Kitchen. When you come in, your family.
All sponsors of this game broadcast.
Start of the second quarter on Hometown Radio KLGA as North Union leads Bishop Garrigan 19-16. Grady Madden hitting a three-point ball right before the end of the quarter for the Warriors. Bishop Garrigan has the basketball. Furch pull it into Nemers. Nemers sets it in for the easy two.
Oh, what a great design on that play. Good offense by Garrigan. Nemers gets the ball off the screen. Easy bucket.
4 points by Logan Nemers, who's been averaging 10.2 per game. North Union with the basketball up by one, 19-18. Fabio into Ermiter. Deep in the post. Shot blocked by Nemers, and he plucks it out of the air, and he's fouled.
The big man going to work down low, scores a bucket on the offensive end, fights for the rebound there, and it's not easy to get a rebound. Ermiter Lostrom in there really fighting for it, but once he gets it in those mitts, hard to rip it out of Logan Nemmer's hands.
First personal foul against Grady Madden as Michael Joyce collects in the backcourt. Bishop Garrigan trying to avoid the press here as Joyce has it, now flips it up ahead to Mahler. They break the press. Mahler bobbles. He finds Schwab for a three-point ball, and he cans it. Bishop Garrigan up by two.
Oh, Schwab heating up. He's a gamer. He loves the competition, seems to play better when it's a big game.
8 points by Carter Schwab right now. The teams that have beaten Bishop Garrigan this year have stopped one of the two between Schwab and Joyce. So far, Schwab of 8, Joyce of 4. Right corner Madden. Joyce flies by, bounce pass into Lostrom, and he drops it, but he picks it back up along the perimeter. Wings it across to Fondigo in the corner. Works the baseline, but Fondigo was standing out of bounds when he caught that ball. Beanie, that's normally an opposing team thing to happen, but Fondigo lost his place.
Yeah, he was just trying to, he took off with the ball before he realized where he was. He was looking to drive baseline and make something happen, but he dropped that left foot back, caught the line.
Joyce passing out of a double team. Ball got knocked away by Lostrom, but Schwab takes it, jumps and passes up to Furch. Furch sailing in, bangs into Ermiter, shot misses. Nemers had it briefly, but the ball goes into the hands of Lostrom, who uses that off arm to say, get away from me. Now here comes Kyan Jones. Jones jump stopping, dealing to Fothergill. Fothergill works the baseline and gets back out to Jones. 6:36 on the clock. Jones left open, three-point ball in and out, and Schwab has another rebound. Here comes the Bishop Garrigan sophomore up the court, left of the lane. Furch to Joyce on the wing, lets it fly, but they'll wave off the three-point attempt as Joyce traveled.
I say Joyce took a little hop, and he nods his head yes. Joyce, such a calm player, great attitude on the floor. He was just laughing it up with the officials before they inbounded the ball. He's going to be fun to watch. Just a freshman looking for big things out of that guy already.
Well, North Union has forced Bishop Garrigan into some early perimeter shots. Golden Bears are shooting 33% on threes so far this year, leading the conference as the ball is knocked away, and Mahler picks it up for Bishop Garrigan. But the Golden Bears have attempted the least threes, so they're really only taking them if they're open, as Schwab has it left wing. Warriors have clogged the paint pretty well so far tonight, though, as Schwab has the top of the key. Over to the right to Joyce in front of the North Union student section. Into Nemers, works in the post. Ball stripped away by Lofstrom. Great defense that time.
Oh, really impressive hands by Lofstrom. Logan Nemers tries to take a power dribble. Lofstrom swipes it right out of his fingers.
Fothergill far side of the court now. Back up top to Jones. 5:46 on the clock. Into lane Madden. No look pass. A short corner jumper by Ermeter. Rattles off, no good. Offensive board for Madden. Lofstrom pumps left, drives baseline. Gets it back to Madden in the corner. Madden to the paint. Madden working, rising for a jumper, can't knock it down. Nemers had it briefly, ball to the baseline. Lofstrom has it, but he dribbled it off the baseline as he cannot secure the rock.
The North Union with a couple really good looks at the basket, but they're just
oh, and
cold
a technical
now.
Foul. Lofstrom just got called for a technical foul.
Yeah, Lofstrom, I don't think he liked the way that played out when he got stepped on the line. Maybe he felt he got pushed, but he had some words, and these officials are not going to put up with that in this game tonight. And that's going to get the teams riled up. Joyce, of course, is going to go shoot the free throws. Excellent shooter. We'll take these technical fouls here. Technical foul shots. Just 21-19 and a lot of basketball left to be played. 5:30 left to go in the second quarter. Nothing like a technical foul to get everyone riled up.
Joyce misses up the back of the iron on the first one. Joyce is a 76.5% free throw shooter who's averaging just under 18 points per game this season. As the score stays 21-19, Bishop Garrigan.
I think Coach Fisher want to get a quick 30-second timeout. Coach Fisher, Coach of the Year last year, is going to calm this whole team down.
Timeout called by North Union as Joyce knocks down the free throw and makes it 22-19. But Beanie, talking about Coach Fisher, he's done a great job of this North Union program. You go back to the 2020-2021 season, they won two games, and both were against 0-22 Eagle Grove. The year after that, they won eight games. Last year, they went 15-9. Right now, a program best 7-0 start to the season, but getting a lot here from the Golden Bears early in the second quarter.
Yeah, it's very impressive what Coach Fisher has done to build a team up like that. And like I said earlier, it seems like Kyan Jones has been his point guard forever, and it all starts with having a core player like Kyan that can run the floor and distribute the ball. And we've seen the North Union team so far just really move the ball well. You can tell that a lot of hours in the gym. They know where their teammates are at all the time. And Garrigan, on the flip side, is building that chemistry. You know, they go very deep. They've had about 18 different lineups in this year, and now looks like they're locking in.
Six seniors on the North Union roster as Garrigan has it, and Schwab throws it away as Fothergill intercepts the pass. Daniel Fothergill brings it into the front court. Has the top of the keys. He's been averaging 10 points per game this season. Fothergill out to Preston Girdette, who just returned after two early fouls in the first quarter. Girdette deals outside to Cale Jones. Now top of the key to Lofstrom. Over to the right, Fothergill. Down to the baseline, Cale Jones. Corner pocket, Trey. And it's in and out, no good. Rebound briefly controlled by Schwab, but knocked out of bounds. A new lineup on the floor for Garrigan as Mahler, Amari Thomas, Schwab, Bauer, and Joyce are in the game right now.
Yeah, regardless of the substitution, all night Garrigan is going to have a size advantage over North Union. We'll see if they can use that to their advantage. And that may be why North Union...
And an offensive foul against North Union.
Another one
on
Girdette.
Off that inbounds play, and it's Girdette
for his third. Oh, wow, that's big. He's going to have to take a seat until halftime for sure. With 5 minutes left to go in the second, losing one of the starters. Ouch for the Warriors. Amari Thomas is going to take it out. But, Tyler, would you say North Union is settling for the three-pointer, or do you think that's the game plan?
Well, that might be part of the game plan. Garrigan really does a nice job in the lane at the size they have. The ball is knocked out of bounds, and it will go back to North Union. Because that's one thing Coach Fisher talked about the pregame. Of course, Nemers is a starter, but coming off the bench, you have Lear and Thomas. So Garrigan is going to have size in the middle regardless. And I think part of it, too, is you knock down a couple early three-pointers, and you want to keep taking more to really recapture that early heat.
Oh, I suppose so. They were hot a moment ago. Here comes Kyan Jones.
Jones to the elbow. He'll rise for a jumper. Rolls off, no good, as he can't knock down the 15-footer. And Mahler secures the rebound for Bishop Garrigan.
Mahler using his size. They're big all over the place.
Bauer has the basketball for the Golden Bears at the 4.5-minute mark. Right corner, Schwab, his three ball short. Ball tipped in the lane, and Lofstrom plucks it out of the air for the rebound. Still 22-19. Teams have cooled off considerably since the first 4 minutes of this game as Bishop Garrigan leads. Father Gill, far side of the court, works the baseline, stops on the dime, wings it out to Jones, knocked away by Joyce as Jones flags it down near the sideline. Jones stops on the wing. Bauer comes out to defend. Lostrom foul line, right corner to Cale Jones. Tees up a three, and he swishes it. Cale Jones ties the game at 22.
Showing the depth and their shooting ability. Cale Jones probably not expected to shoot a lot of threes.
Cale Jones has been 1 of 9 on three-pointers coming into the game as he knocks down a second of the year, and Fothergill jumps a cross-court pass. Gives to Cale Jones, back out to Fothergill. His three-point ball, too strong, and track-bound by Lostrom on the offensive boards. North Union so far doing a great job on the offensive glass as here comes a second-chance type of possession of a fresh 35. Jones in the corner, gives it to Lostrom on the wing. Bounce pass to the foul line to Lostrom. He floats it up, no good. Power dribble, spins, got it back. He put it up, and he drew the foul. Aiden Lostrom making things happen, and he'll shoot two.
Lostrom has a lot of experience there, and he's got good footwork in traffic. Impressive coming down to that rebound. Amari Thomas and Drew Moeller were in there battling for it, but didn't get a body on Lostrom. The experience showing out there.
Lostrom will shoot 2 free throws. The North Union Warriors are working on 8 straight wins at home. They went 8-3 in this gym last year. So far, 4-0 at home this season as Lostrom cans the free throw for his first point of the night. And it's 23-22 North Union. Moeller will head to the bench for Bishop Garrigan. Right now, Nemers, Thomas, Bauer, Joyce, and Schwab. Lostrom again, and he is good again as North Union goes up by 2. 24-22, 3.5 minutes left. Joyce jumps through the double team and finds Schwab. Schwab across half court, avoids the two Joneses as the ball goes into Thomas off the pass from Joyce, knocked away by Ermiter, and Thomas wrestles it away and saves the possession. Now Joyce has it deep on the wing as the Warrior defense very, very aggressive as Joyce gives to Bauer right side of the court. Bauer of 14 on the shot clock, underhands it to Joyce just inside of the logo, fakes the shot, drives in, deals to Schwab in the corner, but the pass is too tall and off of Schwab's hands.
Oh, Joyce driving hard. He saw Schwab set up for the three-pointer. Driving dish, but no luck that time. Pass goes away and into the hallway.
A timeout call by Bishop Garrigan. A 60-second timeout as we'll step aside on KLGA 92.7 FM.
High school sports on Hometown and Home Country Radio are brought to you by these fine sports club members.
Farmer State Bank is proud to be part of our community. Offices in Algona, Whittemore, and West Bend.
Stroman Dental, giving you something to smile about.
Bill's Auto and Truck Repair. Service is the difference.
Trend Salon, your complete family hair salon. It's all about you.
Oakcrest Funeral Services, celebrating a life lived.
Algona Frame and Auto Body, we meet by accident.
Water Connection, from softeners to bottled water and service, call 295-SOFT.
Algona Pizza Ranch, there's so much to love.
Cotton Grave Farm Management and Land Realty in downtown Algona, trusted for farmland service needs since 1960.
Sponsoring this broadcast on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Out of the Bishop Garrigan timeout. North Union leads Bishop Garrigan 24-22 as the Warriors have the rock right now. Kyan Jones bounces to the foul line to Ermiter, finds Cale Jones in the corner. He'll pump fake, but Schwab closes out as we have 2:53 left in the first half. Back to Jones in the corner. Three-pointer on the way. Too strong. Ball knocked away. Right back to Jones in the corner. Jones wants to drive this time. Threads the pass to Fothergill. Challenges Thomas, and Thomas swallows that shot.
Oh, Amari Thomas gets up there. What a great block by the sophomore.
Bauer in the corner, finds Nemers. Nemers in all kinds of traffic. Ball gets rolled away. Nemers dives on top of it, but he's out of bounds. Lostrom again pumping his fist. The Warrior defense trying to swarm Logan Nemers and keep him off the scoreboard.
Nemers has great position in there and great hands, but whenever he puts that ball on the floor, he's going to have about 4 Warrior hands swatting at that thing. Keep that thing up in the air and knock it in. And here comes the Warriors against the Bishop Gary, and looks like they're setting up with a little bit of a zone here.
Nemers has been held to 4 points so far tonight. Running the baseline is Jones. They find Lostrom. A nice pass to Ermiter. Hesitates. Puts it up. No good. Lostrom the follow up and in.
Yeah, Garrigan setting up that 3-2 zone. North Union immediately realizes they can go down low now and do so.
Schwab's spins away from a double team. The pass into Thomas. Ton of traffic. Thomas tips it to himself. Thomas kisses it off the glass for two.
Amari Thomas, just a sophomore, but just as raw as can be, tons of athleticism, and they've got a lot of high hopes for Amari.
Jones drives, challenges Nemers, misses the left-handed layup, and Thomas grabs the rebound. Outlets up to Bauer. Bauer one-on-one. Bauer flies in. Hacked by Fothergill. Fothergill is not going to give Bauer an easy layup that time, and he'll have to earn it at the free-throw strike.
Oh, that was beautiful basketball. Mano y mano going down the court. Bauer gets airborne. He's an athlete. Fothergill's an athlete. Someone was going to get called for a foul there. And, yeah, good foul, as you said, Tyler. Fothergill did everything he could to make sure Bauer didn't get an and one.
Well, and I'll say this, too. That was great vision by Amari Thomas on that outlet pass because his head was down for a second, but it snapped up. He recognized Bauer immediately, got it there just in time, and Bishop Garrigan will at least get 1 point out of this as Bauer knocks down the first.
Yeah, it's impressive to watch Thomas's improvement as the games go on. Justin Bauer, 6 points so far in the night. That's probably his high for the season.
Second free throw no good as Ermeter vacuums in the rebound for North Union. 26-25 Warriors in this top of iOS battle. A 7-0 Warriors and the 3-3 Golden Bears. Grady Madden, who just checked in, has the rock right now. Takes one dribble into the lane. Fothergill now top of the key. Jones tries to shift the defense. Fothergill sidearms it to Madden. Fothergill cuts. Garrigan covers it up. Madden almost threw it away as Cale Jones tracks it down near half court. Back to the corner to Madden. Rises for a three. No good. Thomas trying to rip the rebound away. Ermeter grabs it out of his hands, but it's a jump ball first.
Jump ball stays with North Union. Thomas and Ermeter both wearing number 33. That's a fun battle to watch going on. These both guys are sweating. And the ref's making sure they're okay, and they say, yeah, we're just playing basketball. Don't worry about it, ref. We're just battling.
That was a big-time rip by Ermeter under the basket trying to steal the ball away from Thomas as he did force the tie-up. Warriors have it with 1:15 left in the half. In the corner is Madden. Now Fothergill bounces it right to Jones. Jones holds the rock. Bauer in front of him. Jones stops the foul line, and he shuffled the shoes.
Yeah, he drugged those shoes. That's the problem with the bright shoes, I guess, Tyler. Easy for those officials to see him dragging. Ermeter's going to get a break here. And Garrigan has Nemers in there with Amari Thomas. Size advantage Garrigan. We'll see if they utilize it.
Wostrom's going to be in for North Union at 6'3", providing their biggest height on the court. Schwab into Thomas. Jumps and catches. He's among the trees, and he draws the foul. Amari Thomas powered it through all kinds of white jerseys.
Boy, Schwab can really see the floor well, and sometimes he sees something that's going to develop, and he knew he could get the ball to Amari if he just got that ball in there, and he did so. You got Thomas, Joyce, Nemers, Schwab, and Bauer on the floor. Bauer with 6 points. Not going to be as highest of the season for sure, but anytime they can get points early from Justin Bauer, it's great. Like, he's a great defender, and the senior on the floor, him and Nemers are the seniors on the floor with a lot of youth.
Thomas misses the first free throw, his second on the way, and that one will rattle and drop through. We are tied at 26. Carter Schwamm so far leading the Golden Bears in assists this season at 4.3 per game, but Joyce and Bauer right behind at 4.2 as the Bishop Garrigan Bears have several ball distributors on the floor right now. Jones is North Union's ball distributor. He bounces to the foul line to Fothergill. Back outside to Jones. Jones takes one dribble, backs back up beyond the three-point line as he heads left, flips it into the corner to Cale Jones, back to Kyan Jones. Top of the key, Fothergill with 39 seconds left in the half. Now Jones on the wing. Surveys the zone defense, finds Cale Jones in the corner. Thomas contests, three-point ball swirls out, no good. And the rebound picked up by Joyce. Joyce weaving into the front court. Wostrom peels it away. Here's Grady Madden. Madden sailing in. A nice find to Wostrom, wide open. And there's an easy two.
North Union regains lead, 28-26. Boy, a lot of lead changes in this first half and ties.
14 seconds left in the half. The shot clock is off. Carter Schwamm has the basketball on the wing, being shadowed by Cale Jones. Top of the key, it's Joyce. Joyce splits two defenders, floats from the foul line. Too strong, rebound is fought for. Wostrom has it with 1 second, and there's going to be no shot before the end of the half. The first half is over, and it is a back and forth, grinded out type of half here at the North Union High School Gymnasium. It's North Union 28 and Bishop Garrigan 26 as we step aside for a timeout on KLGA 92.7 and at the Elgona Radio YouTube stream.
We've got more sports club members making this broadcast possible on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Elgona Livestock, sales every Monday.
Countryside Barbecue Sauce, two sauces for all seasons.
Farm and Home Services, view their listings at farmhomeservices.com.
Holmes Animal Clinic, animals large and small, they love them all.
Style Salon, your salon in Elgona, create yourself.
Dance Connection and Tumbling by Michelle. Passionate about teaching, creative about dance. Visit their studio or danceconnectionbymichelle.com.
Tafe Wellness Center in Algona and Armstrong, keeping athletes in the game with chiropractic care. Take charge of your health.
Signworks for all of your signage needs, as well as printed shirts, caps, and jackets. Stop in or call 295-9544.
Down to Earth Tree Service, your local Algona Tree Service.
Sports Club members bringing you this game.
At Security State Bank, we focus on the needs of local families, businesses, and farmers. Decisions are made locally. We live and work in your neighborhood, helping to keep our local community vibrant and growing. We're involved in local community events. We believe in personalized service and advice that meets or exceeds your expectations. We're Security State Bank in Algona, Burt, and Laverne. Bankers who believe in you. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender. Security State Bank.
High school sports on Hometown and Home Country Radio are brought to you by these fine sports club members.
Farmers State Bank is proud to be part of our community. Offices in Algona, Whittemore, and West Bend.
Stroman Dental, giving you something to smile about.
Phil's Auto and Truck Repair. Service is the difference.
Trend Salon, your complete family hair salon. It's all about you.
Oakcrest Funeral Services, celebrating a life lived.
Algona Frame and Auto Body, we meet by accident.
Water Connection, from softeners to bottled water and service, call 295-SOFT.
Algona Pizza Ranch, there's so much to love.
Cotton Grave Farm Management and Land Realty in downtown Algona, trusted for farmland service needs since 1960.
Sponsoring this broadcast on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Time for North Union High School as the Warriors try to continue their perfect season, getting a big test from the Golden Bears as North Union leads 28-26 at the half. I'm Tyler Vance. My partner is Beanie Bodies. A couple quick numbers from the first half look like this. North Union had a 19-16 scoring advantage in the first quarter. Bishop Garrigan had a 10-9 scoring advantage in the second quarter, bringing us to 28-26 at halftime. The scoring spread around quite a bit. Bishop Garrigan has Carter Schwamm with 8 points, Justin Bauer of 6, Michael Joyce with 5, Logan Embers of 4, and Amari Thomas of 3, all unofficial there. On the North Union side of things, Kyan Jones and Aiden Wallstrom both have 6. Cale Jones has 5. Cody Ermeter's knocked down a couple three-point balls for the Warriors. And Beanie, what a matchup tonight between these two teams. The thing that makes this fun is both teams have a lot of depth. There's a lot of different lineup combinations. There's a lot of different chess pieces that can be moved as far as the type of defense you're playing or the kind of lineups you're playing. And really, it's been an entertaining first half to watch these two coaches try to adjust to each other and match each other's moves.
Yeah, this is fun since they have so many players to utilize. They have really just changed the game. Every minute, it seems like the theme of the game changes. 1 second, we're launching three-pointers. The next second, we're pounding inside. All players are just trying to figure out on the fly. That's just making this a really interesting contest to watch up here in Armstrong tonight. Two teams earlier in the season really trying to figure it out. And boy, Tyler, rebounding has been at a premium. We have seen some major battles for rebounding and really fun play down underneath the hoop. Garrigan with a size advantage usually, but Ermeter and Lostrom really know how to keep that rebounding alive. And boy, there's going to be a key to the second half.
It has been a war on the boards so far tonight, to say the least. And it's jump balls being forced. It's players ripping the ball out of each other's hands, up to the whistle, and maybe even a little bit after the whistle as well. And that's the kind of intensity you want from a game like this, where it's so hard fought over the past couple of years. As I said in the pregame, the home game, or the home team, has won the past four matches between these teams. So North Union trying to keep that streak going. But it's always close. It always finds a way to be close, regardless of what the records
are. Boy, and after that opening tip, it went up to 11 immediately. And I thought, buckle up. This is going to be just a wild and intense night. But both teams kind of settled in there and kind of established maybe going for their game plan on the fly. But that's what I'm really curious, what those coaches are deciding in the locker room. It's a real challenge as a coach here in this contest in particular to make a game plan for the second half. You came in with an overall game plan. Now you're 28-26 led by North Union. Regardless of what you thought was going to be the score at halftime, you got to make the decision. So is what we're doing working? If you're Garrigan, I think you got to say, yeah, like they're getting some good looks at the basket. But North Union has the ability to turn up the intensity on defense. and they're going to have to really decide what they want to do offensively in the second half.
Well, the other interesting thing, too, is going to be the shot selection going forward, because I think it's safe to say neither of these teams' bread and butter is the three-point shot, but both teams really did, you know, at least give it a good old try at the three-point ball and really knocked down a few ones early in the game before things kind of cooled off a bit. But right now you can kind of tell Garrigan defensively, they really don't want to let the guards drive in for North Union, suck in the defense, and then have the easy drop-off to Ermitter. Garrigan's taking that away tonight. But what is open, those 15-footers, those foul-line jumpers, that's what Garrigan is okay with North Union taking. And even the three-point ball to an extent, they're okay seeing North Union shoot from range. And you can kind of say the reverse on the North Union side. They really don't want Logan Nemers to have a 20-point game tonight, and they are adjusting their defense accordingly. So both these teams are kind of trying to force the opposition to the perimeter.
They really collapse around the post really well. And, yeah, pushing it to the perimeter, causing a lot more three-point shots. But it's a high-risk shot tonight. If you shoot a three-pointer tonight either on either team and miss it, your opponent is very skilled at getting run-out layups, and both of these teams can move the ball up the floor fast. Joyce and Schwab love to get out and run the floor, open layups, and, of course, Kyan Jones and company, boy, they're brilliant when it comes to flying up the floor with that ball. So if you're going to take a three-pointer, you better be pretty confident in your make percentage.
So that is what we've seen at halftime as the first half has wrapped up, and it's 28-26, North Union on top of Bishop Garrigan in this highly contested top of Iowa West matchup from North Union High School. We'll step aside for a couple of quick messages and come back for the second half next on 92.7 KLGA and the Elgona Radio YouTube stream.
We've got more sports club members making this broadcast possible on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Elgona Livestock, sales every Monday.
Countryside Barbecue Sauce, two sauces for all seasons.
Farm and Home Services, view their listings at farmhomeservices.com.
Holmes Animal Clinic, animals large and small, they love them all.
Style Salon, your salon in Elgona, create yourself.
Dance Connection and Tumbling by Michelle. Passionate about teaching, creative about dance. Visit their studio or danceconnectionbymichelle.com.
TAFE Wellness Center in Elgona and Armstrong. Keeping athletes in the game with chiropractic care. Take charge of your health.
Signworks for all of your signage needs, as well as printed shirts, caps, and jackets. Stop in or call 295-9544.
Down to Earth Tree Service, your local Elgona Tree Service.
Sports Club members bringing you this game.
When you need cash on the go, there's no need to pay a surcharge fee with MoneyPass. Iowa State Bank is proud to be part of the MoneyPass network of surcharge-free ATMs found nationwide. Look for the green and blue MoneyPass symbol on over 32,000 ATMs across the nation. Or find an ATM near your vacation spot or travel destination at MoneyPass.com. MoneyPass, another way that Iowa State Bank helps people succeed. Member FDIC.
High school sports on Hometown and Home Country Radio are brought to you by these fine sports club members.
American Glass. For all your glass needs, think American.
Farm Bureau Financial Agents Dave Beisch, Jason Brace, Daniel Folk, and Michael Toth.
Kemco Tires. They're all you need to know about tires and service.
Weikert Realtors, the 515 Agency, a fresh approach to real estate.
Billy Offerman, your State Farm Insurance Agent in Elgona. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Iowa Lakes Community College, your community, your college.
Lusher Family Dentistry, serving your family since 1965 on Call Street in Elgona.
BMC Advantage Insurance Services, insuring our neighbors for over 80 years.
Walker Chiropractic and Wellness, caring for Elgona, Sway City, and the surrounding areas with chiropractic, nutritional, and physical therapy services.
All sponsors of this game broadcast.
At Security State Bank, we focus on the needs of local families, businesses, and farmers. Decisions are made locally. We live and work in your neighborhood, helping to keep our local community vibrant and growing. We're involved in local community events. We believe in personalized service and advice that meets or exceeds your expectations. We're Security State Bank in Elgona, Burt, and Laverne. Bankers who believe in you. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender. Security State Bank.
Turn it up. Getting
ready to start the second half here at North Union High School as the North Union Warriors lead the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears 28-26. I'm Tyler Lance. My partner is Beanie Bodie. Beanie, what's going to be the biggest deciding factor in the second half as these teams have traded leads multiple times? They're kind of looking for that thing to tilt the game over the edge.
One of these teams is going to go on a big run. They're going to get the tempo going their way. They're going to go on a streak and score 10 in a row, and then it's going to be hard for the opponent to recover from that. It is really a toss-up. I don't know if it's going to be Bishop Garrigan or North Union, but one of these teams, I feel like, is going to go on a run here in this third quarter and challenge the other team to come back.
So 28-26 North Union. Warriors had a 19-16 scoring advantage in the first. Offense slowed down on the second as Bishop Garrigan had a 10-9 scoring advantage in the second stanza. To begin the second half, the Golden Bears will have the basketball heading from left to right on the radio dial. Both teams have returned. They're starting five to the ball game as Schwab passes right to Bauer, and we're rolling in half number two. Mahler catches in the high post, takes one dribble and gets it back outside to Schwab. Schwab underhands it out to Joyce, and an offensive foul to start the second half by Bishop Garrigan.
Well, that's the third moving screen called on Bishop Garrigan. They're working on their offensive execution, and either those screens aren't tight enough, or North Union's doing a really good job of fighting through them and creating some contact that's excessive. But boy, yeah. That's a three turnovers there as Fothergill inbounds it to Jones.
That's the first foul picked up by Drew Mahler, and the Warriors will have their first possession of the second half. Wallstrom down on the corner gives to Jones. Around the perimeter to Fothergill as he finds Girdette. Girdette played sparingly in the first half as he picked up three fouls. Corner pocket three, Ermiter off the back of the cup. Mahler tips the rebound, but he tipped it right to North Union, and Girdette collects the basketball. Wallstrom got it out to Girdette. Girdette fought about the three, got it to Wallstrom instead. Now Fothergill on the wing. All the way across the corner, Girdette leaping grab to save the turnover, then throws it to Jones. It's off the hand of Bauer out of bounds, and it will stay with North Union.
Good hands by Bauer. I thought he almost knocked that off of Jones. Boy, a moment ago, a little girl came in with two bags of popcorn. About got run over by a North Union player. That was fortunate. That would have been a first time game stopped for popcorn on the floor.
Good thing they were efficient at the concession stand, because that would have been a disaster. That would have been a delay for a team that cannot afford a delay getting ready for tomorrow,
right,
as well.
In this tight gym, there's got to be some food on the floor eventually.
Nick Lear is into the ballgame for Bishop Garrigan, replacing Drew Mahler. First time we've seen number 35 tonight for the Golden Bears. Eight on the shot clock for North Union. They work around the perimeter. Fothergill looking to create. Fothergill pivots. Gets it out to Girdette. Has to hoist the horn, and it bounces in. The rubber rim by Girdette, and it's 31-26 North Union.
Wow, just hit the front of the rim and deadened. Unbelievable shot by Girdette, who spent most of the half on the bench with three fouls.
Girdette, a 32% three-point shooter so far this season, averaging just under 12 points per game, as Schwab has to get rid of the rock, and he gives it off to Joyce. Joyce, with 5 points in the first half, stops for a mid-range J, left it short. Lear off its board, puts it right back up, and he puts it off the window for two.
Oh, big board by Lear. He stands about 6'6". He can get off the floor as well, does so on that rebound, battling physically.
And Lear and Nemers playing at the bottom of that 3-2 for Garrigan. It's a three-point ball. Girdette, no good. And Bauer sails in for the rebound. Three-point lead by North Union. Schwab, top of the key, guarded by Fothergill. Fothergill draws a lot of the toughest defensive assignments for North Union. Nemers in the post. Try to get the pass to Lear. Had an open look, but it's off his hands and out of the bounds as Lear looks at his hands in frustration.
A great idea by Nemers. Threw that down around Nick Lear's waist. And Nick was thinking Logan was going to shoot it and was getting ready to rebound. Just a miscue for the Bears, unfortunately. Could have been a dunk for Lear, maybe. That's hard to say.
5:54 on the clock from the lane. Wallstrom hooks it with left hand and missed it as Lear grabs another board. The Bishop Garrigan sophomore, Carter Schwab, has it. Drives right of the paint, fights it through contact, and he draws the foul. Two free throws coming for Carter Schwab.
Oh, are they going to call Girdette on that one? He's coming over, and he is not. He is going to call
Lofstrom. That is number two on Lofstrom, and that is a much preferable result for North Union rather than get a number four on Girdette.
Yeah, there were three Warriors there. It was kind of pick a Warrior, because when Schwab goes in the lane, you're either going to foul him or he's going to score. And so you got to collapse on him and foul him. And then it's kind of pick a mix of which guy's going to foul him as they all collapse.
And some of the struggles in the free throw line continue for Schwab. He's been under 47% this season and can't knock down the first one, as the second one is perfect, and that'll make it 31-29. When Schwab comes downhill, that is a Bishop Garrigan state championship winning offensive lineman coming downhill at you. That's not just anyone.
Yeah, you don't want to take that charge.
You're dead on the wing. Dribbles towards the right, threads it to the baseline, reversing, and it popped out. Fothergill almost had a sweet reverse, and now the Golden Bears come the other way. Bauer sails in, puts it off the glass, no good, and that's got to be a goaltend. Yeah, North Union flew in and they hit the glass. So that's a goaltend, and the game is tied at 31.
Yeah, I believe that was Ermiter skying and hit the backboard. Impressive, but it's going to be a deuce for Bishop Garrigan. But go back to that baseline move by Fothergill. I've been waiting for him to do that. He's very comfortable on the baseline. He's driven baseline multiple times only to pass it up. That time he made it all the way to the hoop and got everything except the net.
Jones pulls up for a top of the key triple. Missed it left as Weir grabs the rebound. Quickly up ahead to Joyce. Garrigan does not have numbers, so Joyce will wait for the rest of the teammates to catch up. Hands it off to Schwab, far side of the court. Schwab spins, finds Nemers, a 15-footer from the foul line, and it pops in. It rattled and stayed down as Garrigan's up by two.
Sweet touch for the big man. Here comes Kyan Jones.
Bishop Garrigan on a 7-0 scoring run right now. They've grabbed the lead at 33-31. Jones to the baseline, into the lane to Lofstrom, and Lofstrom sets it in to tie the game.
Beautiful dish by Jones to Lofstrom. A little pressure now applied. Here comes Schwab.
Schwab bursting down the lane, and he got pushed. That'll be a foul on North Union, their second of the quarter.
Yeah, boy. They are shocked with that call, but once again, Schwab, when he gets that ball in the open court and starts going downhill.
Number three against Fothergill, so Fothergill and Gerdet both had three fouls. Gerdet goes to the bench. Grady Madden into the ballgame, the North Union junior.
Now that really changes the dynamic of the game. It's tied here at 33.
Schwab tried to find Nemers, knocked away by Fothergill, and Madden has the basketball, 4:38 on the clock.
Because when you get that third foul on you, it changes your approach. You don't want to get that fourth one, and you I don't want to say you play softer, but you just do things differently.
Madden turns for a 15-footer and rattles it in. Madden from mid-range makes it 35-33. One, two, do you trust now Fothergill to guard Schwab? Right now he is, but Schwab might be seeking out a four-foul Fothergill, one of their best defenders for North Union. Nemers in the high post gets it back out to Joyce. Joyce splits down the lane, taking big strides. Got to the rack and scored.
Well, it just wasn't going to be denied there. Very powerful move by Joyce.
Pass all the way from half court to the baseline, finds Fothergill, now Madden in the corner. Gets it into Ermiter, bangs into Nemers. Shot no good, it's too long. Veer quickly gets it out to Schwab as Schwab runs the floor. Schwab having trouble controlling the ball, and it's taken away by Jones. Jones outrunning everyone. Jones sails in, stripped by Bauer, but a foul. Justin Bauer picks up this
They're
going to
call an intentional. Intentional foul on Justin Bauer. Boy, he sure got a lot of ball. That's going to be a controversial call here. They're going to talk about it. Yeah, the officials want to get together and talk about it, but it looks like the intentional call is going to stick.
Yeah, so this is going to be free throws and possession for North Union.
Tell you what, Kyan Jones made a nice steal and was going down. Justin Bauer, like Jesse Owens, comes flying down the court. Tyler, where did he come from? He was flying. That was unbelievable speed. In fact, that might have contributed to the intentional foul. He was going so fast, he had to use some body to slow him down because he still went careening into the wall at about 20 miles an hour.
Kyan Jones now has 7 points. And behind the baseline, there's about, I don't know, 3 feet of space, and then there's the wall. So there's no room to stop as Jones knocks down the free throw and North Union up by two.
You know, both teams playing well now. Yeah, another lead change, and ties and lead changes have been the recipe. North Union's going to get the ball back, but now Amari Thomas is in along with Lear. Garrigan got a lot of height in there, but Nemers is on the bench, and he's been an offensive powerhouse this second half.
Into the lane, Ermiter. Shot rejected by Lear, and here comes Joyce. Joyce running the floor. Joyce sailing in. Too strong on the layup. Lear got the miss. Lear fights it up through contact, and he got the foul. That's one of where your North Union, you're going to want a jump ball there. I think Fothergill thought that was a jump ball, and that's going to be foul four on Fothergill.
Wow, he's going to have to take a seat, and that really changes the offense for North Union. A lot of their offense goes through that pass to Fothergill in the corner. Nick Lear, what a boost off the bench here in the second half. Block shots, rebounding.
Lear on the way,
and
he swishes
throw.
The free throw. I'll tell you what, if I'm North Union, I'm really upset about that because that was very, very close to jump ball. That's kind of the reverse of Bauer. That was a lot of ball, maybe a little bit of hand, but that is a damaging foul against Fothergill. And he took a risk on defense there.
Yeah, that was a risk on defense, but yeah, there was a definitely held ball situation there.
Lear too strong on the free throw. Ermiter rebound as he boxes out Bauer. And a 3:40 on the clock. It's 37-36 North Union. Warriors have Cale Jones in the ballgame in place of Fothergill. Lofstrom high post comes out to Ermiter. Rotates to Madden. Pump fakes Bauer. Starts to drive. Lost the ball. And here comes Schwab. Carter Schwab with the turnover. Challenges Ermiter. And he will travel.
Oh, Schwab with the travel. He was going in with his left hand. He's stronger with his right. Goes to his left hand. He gets called for the travel. We'll call that a wash here. Here comes the ball.
North Union outlet pass up to Jones in the corner. Doesn't land and passes to Madden. Right back to Jones. Cale Jones free. Too short. And the rebound is plucked out of the air by Lear for Bishop Garrigan. Here comes Carter Schwab. Finds Michael Joyce on the wing. Guarded by Cale Jones, a 3:09 on the clock. Joyce hits the spin move, and he spun too hard as he travels.
They're going to call Joyce on the travel on the spin move. He's going to hustle back down and shakes his head. Yep. Joyce, talk about being aggressive this third quarter. He is going to the basket with a fury.
Top of the key, it's Kyan Jones. Jones picks up his dribble into the center of the paint to Madden. They swarm Madden. Madden, no look, fine. Irvinger sets it in. What a pass by Grady Madden. Fooled everybody.
He did. Right in the middle of the lane. No look to Irvinger.
He split the uprights between Lear and Thomas. That was a tight window. 39-36 in favor of North Union. Joyce contested for E-ball, and it deflects off to the near side. No good as Jones flags down the board. Kyan Jones whips it up ahead to Madden. Madden thought about the three. He wants the pass instead, and he traveled.
Boy, you can see both these teams, they can feel a run happening. They're both trying to. And, boy, every time a team tries to get something going, they shoot themselves in the foot. Here it's a 39-36 contest in favor of the Warriors. We'll see if Garrigan is going to calm it down here. North Union putting on some pressure.
Madden was campaigning there to try to get them to change their mind, as he said he didn't travel, but Schwab has it for Bishop Garrigan. Schwab goes right to the cup and lays it in.
Oh, Schwab making him pay for the full court press. He got by four defenders all the way to the rack.
39-38, turnovers an issue on both sides tonight. In the corner, it's Madden, steps back for a tray, and it deflects up the glass, no good. Ready-made fast break for Joyce. Joyce sidesteps, Joyce up the window, he put it down, and a foul! Michael Joyce with a chance for a three-point play, and Bishop Garrigan's up 40-39.
Wow, just explosive speed by Joyce. You called it, Tyler. He got that ball, ready-made fast break. He was off to the races. Boy, Garrigan with Bauer and Joyce on the floor can match the speed of any team here on the fast break.
Joyce coming off a 20-point game against Garner Hay from Ventura. He shot 8 of 12 from the field and 4 of 5 on three-pointers. Tonight it's been more attacking on the drive as Joyce misses right on the free throw, and Ermiter picks up another board for North Union. Ermiter, the number 2 rebounder in the top of Iowa West at 8.7 points per game, and Coach Alex Fisher wants a timeout with 1:58 left in the quarter. Timeout called by North Union, as they will have 3 timeouts left. We'll take a timeout with Coach Fisher on KLGA 92.7 and at the Elgona Radio YouTube stream.
We've got more sports club members making this broadcast possible on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Reeves Wicked Good Bar and Grill. For wicked good food, drinks, and service, you gotta go to Reeves.
CB Grain Solutions, satisfaction guaranteed.
New Way K&H Co-op, delivering exceptional value through knowledge and innovation.
Dump It, they do the dirty work so you don't have to.
Elbert Electric, flip the switch to Elbert Electric.
Grassmasters, growing satisfied customers.
Greg Penning and Company, certified public accountants, where everyone counts.
Yemlin Builders and Apartments, quality apartments for rent, beauty and craftsmanship that will never go out of style.
Daylight Donuts, open early with delicious donuts and great coffee.
All sponsors of this game broadcast.
Environment and a great game so far inside the North Union High School gymnasium. Bishop Garrigan up 40-39 as Ermiter misses wildly on that shot. And Schwab grabs another board for Bishop Garrigan. Schwab pump fakes. He'll rise for a three-pointer. Left it way short, and Jones has the rebound. Jones spins away from Justin Bauer with 1:41 on the clock as Kyan Jones passes to Ermiter. Ermiter squares up for a three-point ball. Line drived it. Ball tipped out, and Schwab tracks down yet another rebound.
Yeah, Garrigan definitely winning the rebounding margin here in the third quarter with a minute and a half left to go.
Schwab's been averaging 6.2 boards per game. Bauer somehow found Thomas in the post. Thomas lays it in. A beautiful pass by Bauer. A catch in traffic by Thomas in the finish.
What a risky pass Bauer makes, but Thomas in the middle of three defenders goes up and gets it. Big bucket for the Soft.
5 points by Amari Thomas. Jones in the lane, scoops it under the arm of Nemers, but missed the shot as it rolled around the cup. And now here comes Schwab yet again. 42-39 Garrigan. Schwab drop off for Thomas, and he lays it in.
Oh, beautiful assist by Schwab, running the floor with some speed.
Coach Meister loves it. He jumps off his seat on the bench and pumps his fist as North Union tries to answer. Nemers jumps the pass. Here comes Bishop Garrigan of Joyce. Joyce flies in. Joyce gets hacked. two free throws coming from Michael Joyce with 46 and a half seconds. Coach Fisher called the timeout for North Union, but since then, Garrigan has continued to keep the momentum.
That's right. Talk about momentum swing. Coach Fisher calls the timeout, gets exactly what he wanted, a set play to Ermiter, but Ermiter missed it, and then Ermiter missed a three-pointer, and man, Garrigan was off to the races. Here's that run I knew someone was going to do in this third quarter. It was Garrigan just seizing the moment, turning up the heat, and getting these fast break points.
Joyce free throw on the way, left it short. It's been a tough night at the line for Joyce. Bishop Garrigan is a team just 55.6% from the field this season. Number 8 of 9 teams in the conference. As Trayton Sink checks into the ballgame for Bishop Garrigan, Nemers heads to the bench. For North Union, Geardeck comes back in as Ermiter goes to the pine.
Right, and now Fothergill's been on the bench with four fouls for a lot of this third quarter. He'll come back in the fourth.
Joyce splits the pair. 45-39, Bishop Garrigan. Warriors in an unfamiliar spot right now. They've been a great second-half team this season, but Bishop Garrigan has had the upper hand in the third quarter. Jones, top of the key. Flips right to Cale Jones off the pass from Kyan Jones. Back to Kyan. Rotates left to Grady Madden. Madden looking to enter the lane. 29 seconds left on the game clock. Madden guarded by Thomas. Thomas kicks it away, and that'll stop the clock with 26 seconds left.
15 seconds left on the shot clock. That won't reset, and Madden's going to take it out. So the question with this lineup, Ermiter lacking the inside presence, he's on the bench. Who's going to take the shot? North Union's probably going to have to settle for a three.
23 seconds left in the quarter. A 10 on the shot clock in the corner. Madden dumps it into Wallstrom, quickly out to Geardette. Right wing Trey, line drives it. Offensive board for Jones, and Jones is pushed. That is foul number three against Bishop Garrigan. It comes with 15.6 seconds left in the quarter against Trayton Sink.
Good athleticism by Cale Jones. He comes flying in from the far corner and elevates to keep that rebound alive. Got a push by Joyce to the floor. Joyce helps him right back up. Good sportsmanship there by the freshman.
Personal foul three on Sink. North Union is 12 seconds in the shot clock off. Jones jumps up into the paint. Flips a wild shot. No good. Off the hands of Wasserman. Out of bounds. That was not the way North Union wanted that possession to go. And Bishop Garrigan will get one final shot before the end of the quarter.
Jones looking calm and composed. He knows he can do that. They wanted a better shot, but as a senior out there, he had to make something happen. Coach Fisher's going to get him out, give him an extra 7 seconds of break here before the end of the quarter. And Garrigan has a huge opportunity with this 7 seconds.
Drew Henderson in for North Union. It's a 1-2-2 full court press. 4 seconds left in the quarter. Bauer to the cutting. Schwab fades for a jumper. Left it short. And Madden grabs the rebound at the end of the third quarter. What a treat we have set up for us in the fourth quarter. North Union and Bishop Garrigan battling it out right now. It's Bishop Garrigan 45, North Union 39 on KLGA 92.7 and at the Elgona Radio YouTube channel.
When you need cash on the go, there's no need to pay a surcharge fee with MoneyPass. Iowa State Bank is proud to be part of the MoneyPass network of surcharge-free ATMs found nationwide. Look for the green and blue MoneyPass symbol on over 32,000 ATMs across the nation. Or find an ATM near your vacation spot or travel destination at MoneyPass.com. MoneyPass, another way that Iowa State Bank helps people succeed. Member FDIC.
Bishop Garrigan has lost their last two games inside the North Union High School gymnasium, but right now they are 8 minutes away from upsetting the Warriors early in this season. It's Bishop Garrigan 45, North Union 39 in this boys' high school matchup. And if you're wondering why the boys are going first tonight, well, it's because North Union is going all the way over to Sioux City, that is, tomorrow. The boys will play at 10 a.m. for North Union, so they want to get this boys' game underway first and play the girls second tonight. And boy, what a treat you've had to start this game, Beanie.
That 10 a.m. wake-up call is going to come even earlier if they lose this game to Bishop Garrigan. At the end of that quarter, Tyler, all the Bishop Garrigan faithful up here in the second level, boy, they got to their feet, gave a little standing ovation to the Bears because they know this is the best they've seen the Bears play this year.
Working the baseline, Madden gets it to Wallstrom. On the perimeter to Cale Jones, his three-point ball misses left, and Ermiter snatches the offensive board away from Nemers, and a push called against Bishop Garrigan. That'll be the first foul on the Golden Bears of the quarter, but you know, I'll say this, I think Garrigan's game on Tuesday against Garner Vehicle Ventura was their best game of the season, but so far this is their best three quarters, and it depends how the final 8 minutes go here.
Yeah, I agree with you, Tyler, there. Logan Nemers called for the push, does a prayer hands there, pleading with the official. That's not going to work, Logan. Here comes Wallstrom with the ball fake.
Into the corner to Cale Jones, and he traveled. Jones faked baseline, then tried to pass right.
He
faked
did.
A little too hard.
He just faked and took 3 steps in doing so. He knew he did it as soon as that whistle blew.
This is a crew that calls the travel very, very tightly. Both teams have been called tonight, and you cannot get away with what you can on some other nights. As Schwab wings it up to Nemers, Bishop Garrigan breaks the press. Bauer in the right corner finds Thomas in the post. Backing in against Ermeter, no space to work. Gets it out to Joyce. Ermeter stood his ground that time as Schwab gets to Nemers in the corner. Nemers three-point arcing up, and in and out, no good. Rebound by Ermeter. The Bishop Garrigan, half of the crowd would have blown up if that had gone down. Madden threads the needle to the baseline to Gerdet, and it's off his hands and out of bounds.
Yeah, Gerdet just stumbled a little bit and bounced that ball off his own shins out of bounds. No contact there, just an unforced turnover there. Oh, no. North Union really turning up their press here. Garrigan as a team has been excellent at breaking it, and here they did it again.
They break it again. Here comes Joyce. Hangs from the paint, and he drops it in. Michael Joyce makes it 47-39. He has 12 points. Ball knocked out of bounds.
Schwab hit the ball into a first row, and it hit a fan from North Union there. And Schwab checks, makes sure she's okay. She says, I'm fine. Don't worry about it. She's a tough fan down there in the first row of the bleachers. Boy, Tyler, North Union has an excellent press, but Garrigan has a lot of teams that try to press him. And with Schwab and Joyce handling the ball, and as a team, they work on their press breaker a lot. Really tough to press Bishop Garrigan.
And playing at a fast pace is in Bishop Garrigan's DNA, so they're not afraid to turn up the speed a little bit, as both teams have tried to increase the pace this year. Gerdet sailing in, and he lays it off the window for two.
Wow, what a move by Gerdet. Spinning, juking, and jiving all the way to the hoop.
Taking long, deliberate strides as well. And Gerdet has 7 points for the Warriors. 6:50 left in the fourth quarter, 47-41, Bishop Garrigan. As Schwab will dribble at the North Union logo at half court. Joyce comes up to screen, Schwab heads right. Now Cale Jones has switched on to Schwab. Schwab picks up his dribble and finds Nemers in the high post. Nemers pivots away from trouble and gets it back up top to Joyce. Nemers screens. Joyce finds the rolling Nemers. Passes behind him and off his hands as Thomas can't save it back into play.
Oh, that was a nice set pick and roll. I love that play. Just didn't execute it. Nice setup by Bishop Garrigan there. Good call. Just didn't execute it. Now North Union has a chance to cut into the Garrigan 6-point lead.
47-41 in favor of Bishop Garrigan. Golden Bears had a 19-11 scoring advantage during the third quarter as Fothergill's back in for North Union. Gerdet hands it off to Fothergill. Fothergill working patiently in the high post. Bounce pass to Lofstrom. Lofstrom against Thomas. Lofstrom trying to go underneath Thomas. Lays it up and in.
A good move by Lofstrom. Garrigan is in a 3-2 zone, so just two people down low. And if North Union gets the ball in there, they got a chance.
10 points, Aiden Lofstrom. Now Joyce sailing in, banging into Ermeter. That's an offensive foul. Or banging into Lofstrom, that is, I believe. And Joyce gets called for the charge.
Oh, Lofstrom takes a good, solid charge. Every time I see these guys play over the years, Lofstrom is fantastic at setting up and drawing charges. He did so there against Joyce, who has been going to the basket with authority this whole half, looking strong. By that time, gets tagged for the charge, and he shakes it off.
Lofstrom just looked at Coach Alex Fisher and gave him the most casual nod I've ever seen after making a great play. He just said, that's what I do.
Yeah. Joyce did the same thing. He's like, that'll happen.
Bauer steals the ball away from Fothergill. Fothergill pokes it back away. Bauer picks it up. Bauer finds the cutting Thomas. Thomas flying in.
Oh!
Missed on the layup. That's a big miss for Garrigan, and North Union has the rebound as Bishop Garrigan goes one and done. Jones gives to Lofstrom, right back to Jones on the wing. Garrigan dares him to shoot briefly. He holds it. He passes into lane to Ermeter. Ermeter shoots over Thomas, left it short, and Thomas grabs the rebound. Schwab gets it up ahead to Joyce. Joyce far side of the court, flips it back out top to Schwab. Schwab towards the right, flips back over to the left as he backs up near half court. Gerdet flying at him right now. Fothergill's guarding Bauer. Gerdet is guarding Schwab. So that is a swish from earlier and a whistle and a stoppage here as Bishop Garrigan wants a timeout.
That was a timeout by Schwab, I believe, I think. They're going to get a 30-second timeout. And good job there by Carter Schwab, the sophomore. The Garrigan offense wasn't doing anything, and he was getting pressured big time up top by Gerdet. Schwab's not going to give up the ball. He's got the size advantage over Gerdet, but he was not going to be able to get anything going from that position. So smart timeout by the Garrigan team. 30 seconds here. They got a 4-point lead. Tyler, this is where that shot clock they instituted a couple years ago really plays in, because if, you know, these teams used to get these leads in these fourth quarters and just kind of sit on the ball and trying to force the issue. But with that shot clock, it's going to be exciting up to the final bell here.
Yeah, we forget. Last year was the first year of the shot clock, so this is really year number two of that. And like you said, Beanie, the end of the game will flow much more like a normal basketball game throughout the state of Iowa, obviously, if the shot clock. I have not heard a coach yet complain about having a shot clock. Let me put it that way.
Just got to find one more person to volunteer on the board.
No doubt. Bauer on the right wing. Tried to thread it into Thomas. Kick ball violation, no, against Grady Madden, as Garrigan will keep it.
You know, Garrigan has played nine guys tonight, and whether you're playing Thomas or Lear or Nemers, they're inside, or Moeller when he's been playing inside, their inside game has been great tonight.
Schwab looking, waiting for Bauer to come open, and he does. Bauer is guarded by Madden right now. Here comes Jones on the double team. Bauer gets it away. Joyce tried to throw it to Thomas. Knocked away and picked up by Jones. Kyan Jones for North Union. Jones across half court. Thomas guards him briefly. Now Bauer picks him up. A pass to Madden in the corner. Quick pass inside, but Thomas is in front of it to knock it out of bounds.
The whole risky pass there from Madden to Lofstrom. Thomas is going to get a break. Big round of applause from them. Good minutes from the sophomore. Lear, the tall junior, is going to replace him.
47-43. Bishop Garrigan leads North Union. Jones on the wing as Garrigan gives him a couple feet of space. Now top of the key, Fonagill. In the paint, Wallstrom. Wallstrom back into left corner to Jones as he rotates to Fonagill. Finds the cutting. Gerdet. Oh, a nice pass to Wallstrom underneath as Wallstrom works the baseline and sets it in for two.
Oh, good teamwork there. Great passing by North Union. What a contest we're seeing tonight.
Two-point game, Aiden Wallstrom with 12 points, and Bishop Garrigan's lead is down to 47-45. This is a 6-0 run going on by North Union. Bauer looking, finding Nemers in the post, back out to Bauer quickly, drops the ball, gets it right back to Nemers, backs his way in, shot blocked from behind, Madden got a hand on it, Nemers trying to trace it down, and he has it. 12 on the shot clock, Schwab in the lane, floats over Wallstrom, he put it in, and the foul! Carter Schwab, an opportunity for a three-point play.
What a turn of events. Wallstrom went up, thought he had that rebound, I'm sorry, I think it was Fonagill, and Nick Lehrer kept it alive, kind of tapped it out there, and then it became a mad scrum for it right at the top of the key. Anybody could have come up with that thing. It goes to Schwab, and who's better at getting a hard physical bucket in the lane? Does that with his left hand, which is a strong one, as he drills that free throw with his left hand. That's a big three-point play, Tyler.
50-45, Bishop Garrigan. Carter Schwab of 14 points tonight. Halfway done on the fourth quarter, Bishop Garrigan trying for a road upset as Garrett launches a three and he drills it. They left him open and he knocks it down. It's a two-point game.
Yeah, they just dared him to do it, but Garrett answers the call. Wow.
Garrett is not the one to dare on North Union as he has 10 points tonight. Schwab at the foul line, back to the bucket, gets it out to Bauer. 3:42 on the clock. Bauer looking inside to Nemers. Nemers turns, jumper on the way, too strong. Madden had the rebound. He almost threw it out of bounds, but he saved it into Jones. North Union avoids disaster, and here comes Jones. Finds Fonagill, open on the wing. He'll drive, he'll stop, back out top to Jones. Less than 3.5 minutes left in the ballgame as Bishop Garrigan clings to a two-point lead. Jones dared to shoot it. He left the three-pointer short, and a foul on the rebound.
That's on Madden. Madden was running over to try to keep the rebound alive. He ran over Lear, who was just waiting for the ball to come into his breadbasket. Bears up 2 points, are going to take it out against this North Union press with Bauer, Schwab, and Joyce, who have had no problem so far with the press. Boy, you got Fonagill out there playing with four fouls.
Two fouls on both teams right now in the fourth quarter as Lear gives it to Schwab. Schwab in front of the auditorium bleachers on the far side of the court. Now Joyce over to Justin Bauer. Bauer shadowed by Madden with 3:05 left in the fourth quarter. Pass to the right, almost jumped by Gerdet as Gerdet tipped it out of bounds by a fingernail.
Oh, that was almost a double tip. Gerdet tipped it, and it looked like it almost grazed Michael Joyce. Michael Joyce did a great job making sure he yanked his hand back.
Bishop Garrigan up by two. Schwab to set things in motion. Finds Nemers just outside of the paint. Try to get it back out to Schwab. Knocked away by Jones with the active defense for North Union.
And players fall into the first row of bleachers. Got the seniors down there, Brendan Plath, Violet, Bodie, Ava. They all catch the player, send him back to the floor.
15 on the shot clock, Nemers in the post, backs the way in, shots up and good. Fonagill tried to contest that one, but could not pick up a fifth foul. Nemers has 8 points.
I think Nemers just unstoppable. You get him the ball that deep on the block, he's scoring.
Fonagill dribbles near the top of the key, rotates it left to Gerdet. 2:40 left in the fourth quarter. In the lane, Madden. Madden threads to the cutting Jones. Jones among the trees, and a push against Bishop Garrigan. The third team foul on the Golden Bears.
Yeah, that's going to be on Nemers, I think. Jones just ricocheted right off him. He tried to body up Nemers to go up strong to the hoop. Good move. And Nemers wasn't going to give any ground, and he just bounces off him. He gets called for his third.
2:34 left. North Union has the basketball after the Bishop Garrigan foul. Number 3 on Logan Nemers. Jones surveys the defense, finds Wallstrom. Power dribble, now back outside to Jones. Rotates it right to Fothergill. Fothergill works the baseline. Lear trying to force him down underneath. The pass to Wallstrom, rejected by Nemers, and a jump ball. Logan Nemers got all ball. Wallstrom doesn't like it. But Bishop Garrigan will get the basketball back, and Coach Fisher will burn another timeout for North Union. Warriors will have two timeouts left as Bishop Garrigan leads 52-48 with 2:20 left on KLGA 92.7 and at the Algona Radio YouTube stream.
For over 40 years, Northwest Iowa Bone, Joint, and Sports Surgeons have maintained one mission: to provide excellence in orthopedic care. Their team of nine physicians offer specialized care in everything from arthroscopic same-day surgery to joint replacement, as well as hand and foot surgery, and have an orthopedic surgeon on call 24/7. Healthcare isn't about appointments, it's about taking care of people, and that's their specialty. Visit Northwest Iowa Bone, Joint, and Sports Surgeons on the web at nwiabone.com.
As we come back here on Hometown Radio, KLGA, Bishop Garrigan leads North Union 52-48 after the block shot, forced jump ball by Logan Nemers. And now with 2:20 left, both teams will have two timeouts. Beanie, what a fourth quarter we've seen. Bishop Garrigan got up 47-39. North Union getting back into it, but a couple big buckets down the stretch here by Bishop Garrigan.
Now, this is an exciting game. I'm hoping for a fifth quarter. This is really entertaining tonight. Both teams really scrapping it out. North Union polished Garrigan. Man, we knew Tyler, and everyone knows Garrigan's loaded with talent. Coming off the football season, it was just a matter of time how they were going to get this talent put together, and it's coming together tonight here in Armstrong.
Bauer lobs three quarters of the court, and it's tipped away. Joyce tried to tip it and keep it alive, but Ermiter gets it off the ill-advised inbounds pass from Bishop Garrigan. North Union with 2:12 left as Jones gives to Wallstrom on the perimeter. Finds Gaudette in the corner. Golden Bears close out quickly on Gaudette after he hit a couple of earlier three-point balls. Wallstrom wings it across to Jones in the right corner, picked up by Joyce. 17 on the shot clock, final 2 minutes in the game, unless there's overtime. 52-48, Bishop Garrigan. Jones looking. Heads left around the perimeter and gives it to Gaudette. Gaudette, three-pointer on the way, missed it right. Rebound tracked down, and Schwab keeps it alive. Carter Schwab running the floor now. Here comes Schwab. A nice dish to Bauer. Bauer baseline jumper, and he knocks it down.
Big points for the senior. Here comes Jones, cool as a cucumber for North Union.
10 points, Justin Bauer. Jones floating into the lane. Shot no good, and Nemers grabs the rebound. Joyce gets it up to Schwab, and there's 1:30 left. Bishop Garrigan 54, North Union 48, and the Warriors quickly foul Carter Schwab. That is team foul number three against North Union.
Boy, in a game with multiple lead changes, and it's been tied several times, a six-point lead by Garrigan feels like a monumental lead for North Union to overcome here with just a minute and a half left to go in the game.
That is foul number four on Gaudette, so Gaudette will head to the bench. Madden in for North Union as Jones almost stole the pass away from Joyce. He got it right back to Schwab with 1:24 left, and now Madden has the foul. That is his third personal and fourth team on North Union as the next one puts Bishop Garrigan in the bonus.
Now Coach Fisher realizing, let's waste no time. Get the 50% free throw shooting of Garrigan to the line as much as possible in this last minute and a half. So they're going to quickly foul again.
Schwab to Nemers, back out to Joyce. Maybe Joyce should have hung on to that one. He got it back to Schwab, and they'll foul Schwab.
And they tried to foul Nemers, and they hacked him, but the big man just bounces right off him. But they're going to get Lostrom for a foul there. He just grabbed a hold. He says he grabbed a hold of Nick Lear, and that will put Nick Lear on the line.
North Union is running out of people who are capable of fouling because four fouls right now on Daniel Fothergill, four fouls on Aiden Wallstrom, and four fouls on Preston Gaudette, who currently sits on the bench. As Joyce will stand in the rebounding position for Bishop Garrigan, Lear will shoot, and it'll be two free throws. Lear takes a deep breath as he tees it up and missed it off to the right.
The North Union still looking poised and composed. Ermiter shows a little frustration. Some of those guys out there, I'm sure, are thinking, wow, how did this happen so fast? This game just kind of flew by.
This is a big one. It's a six-point game right now. This would make it three possessions. 54-48, Bishop Garrigan. Lear again, and missed it too. Ermiter fighting for the rebound. Joyce trying to peel it away. Ball still loose. They're scrapping for it, and that's got to be a jump ball. That is a jump ball, but North Union has the possession arrow.
Well, the North Union fans are hot. Ermiter had position, and he went up for that ball, but Joyce skied up there. He was way off the ground, and he got a hand in there. But North Union fans clearly wanting a foul on Joyce there, but They are going to get the ball. So all's well that ends well here for North Union as they retain possession of the ball. Garrigan will get the next jump, which we have seen several of here in this second half.
Gerdet checks in. Fondigo checks out. Gerdet is likely going to be an offense-only player for the rest of the game with four fouls. Ermiter deals to the cutting man along the baseline. Almost threw it away. Man trying to reverse. Banks it up and in. Timeout by Coach Fisher. North Union desperately needed that bucket, and it's 54-50 as Coach Fisher has one timeout left now. We'll keep it right here with 1 minute left.
Yeah, Tyler, you get the feeling if they don't get that bucket by Madden, and it was not an easy bucket. That was a very highly difficult shot. They are going to be in big trouble. But that cuts the lead to four with a minute left. Madden was really their scorer in the first half, doing some nice shooting from downtown and taking it to the basket there. Then North Union hit this streak where they just didn't have anyone that was putting the ball in the hole, hurt by foul trouble there in that third quarter. And now Coach Fisher is going to try to draw up a press, which has not worked against Bishop Gary tonight. The next foul will put Bishop Garrigan on the line for two free throws. They might be choosing a foul right away.
And at this point, why not? Bishop Garrigan has not shown they're capable of hitting free throws consistently tonight. Well, that can certainly change over the last minute, but if you're North Union, play the foul game and see what happens. Yeah, I think that's the right thing to do.
Coach Meister answers by putting his best free throw shooters in there. Drew Muller's in the game. Excellent free throw shooter. Joyce, Bauer, Schwab, and Nemers.
Schwab gets open. Gerdet can't foul. Schwab has to get away from Gerdet. Gets it up to Bauer. Bauer tried to thread it to Muller. Ball's out of bounds, and he threw it away. A huge mistake by Garrigan at 55 seconds left.
Oh, they were just expecting to get fouled. Schwab saw the opportunity to fast break it, and just throws the ball away. Big break for North Union. Yeah, only 5 seconds go off the clock, not even. Lear's coming right back in for Muller for his defensive presence. He's a shot blocker, as we've seen tonight. A couple blocks on the night for Nick Lear. And here come the Warriors.
Well, that's been the big thing the past 2 years. Composure at the end of games inside this gymnasium for Bishop Garrigan. That has been a question mark. And now they have to hold on up by four. North Union with 46 seconds left. Wostrom with a little space. Gets it out to Jones. Passes up the three. Rotates to Madden. Madden three-point ball got tipped. Falls out of bounds. But did Nemers touch it? Yes, he did. Nemers could not secure the rebound. And North Union has it with 38 seconds left.
Boy, Michael Joyce makes two huge plays this quarter with his elevation. He skied. He got a hand on that ball by Madden. Knocks the three-pointer out of the sky and ran a lot of clock. Already down to 38 seconds, four-point lead. That was clearly off Nemers. I don't know what the officials are talking about. They're just making sure they got it right. And, boy, poor Madden there for the Warriors has got to take it out with no room to move. He's sandwiched between the referee and the cheerleaders and the wall.
19 seconds left. Madden lobs it in to Gerdet. Rotates it over to Jones. Now corner to Madden. Fakes. Gets it back to Jones. Three-point ball on the way. In and out. No good. Fighting for the rebound. Lear. And he is fouled.
Oh, and I think they're calling a jump ball. No, it's not a jump ball. They did call a foul. Madden pleading his case that it's jumped up, that it was a jump ball. But it would have been Garrigan's possession anyway. As it is, Lear is going to go shoot some free throws.
The foul is going to be number four for North Union on Grady Madden. So North Union now four players of four fouls. The players who can foul, Kyan Jones of two and Cody Ermiter of one.
Now, Coach Meister wanted Lear in there to play defense. He was going to sub back in with Muller as soon as he could get back on offense. Now Lear finds himself at the free throw line in a big moment.
Missed a couple on the last trip. He'll try again. Free throw on the way by Lear. Too strong, no good. Still a four-point game.
Lear's trying everything he can with his body language to make that ball go through the hoop. He's leaning. He's begging that ball to go in.
And it doesn't get much louder than this gym as the opposing team tries to shoot down the stretch. It gets quiet for a second. Lear tries again. Missed it right. Rebound loose. And it tips right to Nemers. Nemers gets it out to Schwab. Schwab protects the ball, and he traveled. Oh, Schwab travels with 28 seconds left. And Garrigan continues to give North Union opportunities to get back in the game.
Schwab was just trying to get in the fetal position because he knew he was going to get fouled and took a couple steps in doing so. What a rebound by Nemers, though.
Kyan Jones stops at the foul line jumper. Rims out, no good. Ermiter had the rebound briefly and a push. Ermiter called for the push, and Bishop Garrigan will trek back down for two more free throws.
Wow, if North Union they got to be happy with their shot selection. That was a dead-on look by Jones. Good look at the basket, pull-up jump shot. They've just been cold a lot of the night, and I'm sure Coach Fisher is going to point to that in the postgame. You know, they make some of these shots. In fact, Schwab and Fisher are having a little chuckle on the side right now. It's early in the season for both these teams.
Well, if you think about it, too, Jones, the possession before, had an in-and-out three-pointer. That time, just couldn't knock down the jumper as the free throw no good again from Lear. He's been cold at the free throw line as he's been fouled down the stretch.
Well, I will say, Nick Lear keeping it exciting to the very end.
21 seconds left. Lear Hughes up another free throw. Missed it again. Rebound by Grady Madden. 20 seconds left. North Union has to hustle here. Madden into the lane. Madden reverses. Kicks it out. Gerdet, three-point try. And he swishes it with 11 seconds left. Timeout by North Union. It's a one-point game. Warriors call their last timeout. And all of a sudden, this game is not over. North Union will foul Garrigan. But Garrigan can't go up by two possessions anymore.
Can you believe it? Gerdet, the three-point shooter, swishes that thing in this intense environment. 10 seconds left, 11 in the game. It doesn't matter. Talk about a pressure situation. That young man pulls up and drills a three-pointer. Madden had the ball in the lane just looking for anybody to throw it to. He wanted to go down low. He was a half a second away from a three-second call when he finds Gerdet. Oh, it's a game of inches, seconds, whatever you want to say. Unbelievable game tonight all the way to the very end. One-point lead for Bishop Garrigan.
Woo! Well, whatever Coach Fisher's drawing up in this timeout, it better be good because this is the last timeout for North Union. Bishop Garrigan does have two timeouts left as Coach Meister drawing something up as well. But now the formula, clean inbound play. No traveling when you get the inbound pass. Get it across half court. In fact, North Union will not even let you get it across half court. They'll try to steal, and if they can't steal, they'll foul immediately.
Yeah, I'm sure they're probably going to trap immediately. They might almost even let Garrigan get the ball inbounds just so they can trap immediately and force an errant pass. Because if they get that ball and Garrigan can run their press breaker, it's been dynamite all night. Garrigan's had no problem breaking that press. So if they face guard, Joyce and Schwab have had no problem getting open. Garrigan, in fact, is going to stack it up. Good old-fashioned stack to get someone open.
Nemers inbounding it. It's Bauer, Mahler, Joyce, and Schwab stacked up. North Union will defend here with 12 seconds left. 54-53, Bishop Garrigan on the road. Nemers looking. Nemers looking. Finds Schwab wide open. Schwab protects the basketball, and he's fouled. We'll see who they get that on as Jones and Fothergill converged. If that's on Fothergill,
oh,
he's done.
Gerdet looks upset.
It's on Jones, number 11. So Jones, that is his third foul.
Yeah, and that was a best-case scenario for North Union because nary a second went off the clock. Gerdet and Jones were there so fast on the foul. Schwab, the lefty, is going to try to put Garrigan up by three here, and so North Union will have 10 seconds to either win it with a three or tie it with a three.
Schwab at the free throw line. That one rattles in. Two-point lead by Garrigan. 10.3 seconds left. Carter Schwab with 15 points tonight and a big free throw to try to bulletproof yourself against a three-pointer.
And Schwab imploring his teammates to get your butts back on defense before he shoots his free throw. He talks to both Mueller and Nemers.
Joyce and Bauer right in the backcourt. Schwab knocks down the free throw and Bishop Garrigan calls an immediate timeout with 10.3 seconds left. 16 points by Schwab and now North Union must hit a three-pointer. I'll tell you what, Beanie, if you're North Union, you want to be an elite team, now's the time to be elite. What did I say early in the game? The only thing they're missing is that three-point shooting. They've done pretty well tonight on the three-point balls, and now they need one more than ever.
Boy, they started hot with their three-point shots. Ermeter hit two in a row, and Gerdet's been good with three-pointer, but they were ice cold from the three-point shot. They didn't hit hardly any in the second quarter. Tyler, I know the three-pointer seems like the obvious go-for, but Garrigan's in the timeout right now saying do not give up the three. They're going to come out in a 3-2 type zone probably, do everything they can to defend the perimeter. You have someone like Jones, he can probably go coast to coast in 2.5 seconds and make a layup, and then they can play the foul game again.
Well, another thing, too, Bishop Garrigan can play the foul game as well. They have a foul to give, so they could force North Union to use a couple seconds, foul not in the act of shooting, and force the Warriors to inbound again without the benefit of a timeout to drop a play.
Oh, yeah, that's a good idea, Tyler. I like that call. We'll see what they do here. At the very least, Garrigan can try to just press a little bit, make them take a long time getting the ball up the floor, and it looks like that is exactly what Coach Meister and company are going to do. They're going to make North Union come up against a press.
So the Warriors will have Wostrom as well as Gerdet, Fothergill, Madden, and Jones. Kyan Jones will inbound of 10.3 seconds left. He'll get it into Fothergill. Right back to Jones. Jones bursting up the court. Mahler tried to foul him. He finds Madden in the corner. Three-pointer to tie it. Too long. And the rebound by Michael Joyce with 3.6 seconds left. North Union got a great look at the end of the game, but Madden was too strong on the three-pointer. And now Michael Joyce can try to lock it up with two free throws.
They sure did. What a nice design screen for Madden there in the corner. He's hit a couple of those tonight. He's got his hands on his hip. Knew he missed an opportunity there, but he will live to shoot another three-pointer. That one just sailed off the mark, and Joyce can put it away here with just one make.
And Preston Gerdet fouled out with his fifth foul. Boy, Mahler is trying to foul Jones, but they let it play, and that almost resulted in a North Union three-pointer as Joyce knocks down the free throw. Bishop Garrigan is up by four, and Coach Meister will take his final timeout. Beanie, so much for these teams getting a good night of rest. We're going long tonight in the boys' game, and we still have a whole girls' game afterwards.
Yeah, no kidding. No, Tyler, we talked about that on our way up here to this gymnasium tonight, how both these teams playing big games tomorrow. Garrigan at home against Algona High and North Union on the road in a tournament in Sioux City of sorts. How that's going to play in their psyche before it may have affected this game. In fact, it's affected us. I'm ready to go home after this, but we still have a whole other girls game to do. So, you know, a lot of things changing the atmosphere tonight in this contest, and North Union coming in rolling opponents. But, you know, Garrigan's got a lot of talent down there, and boy, did they show up tonight. Hard-fought game by both teams. Looks like it's going to go Garrigan's way, unless North Union has something up those sleeves that they're not wearing.
Well, now neither team has any timeouts left, so whatever Joyce does here, you've got to do something quickly if you're North Union. If you're Garrigan, you're staying away. No fouling. Again, you're up by four, so it's two possessions. You keep those arms straight up. You don't even touch anybody after this free throw, as Michael Joyce will set up and try to knock down another one. Joyce. No good. Rebound by Cody Ermeter.
Oh, no.
And Bishop Garrigan fouls Ermeter. There was a foul to give.
They're a lane violation.
Oh, lane violation. I beg your pardon.
Yeah, lane violation is going to give Joyce another free throw. Well, you never miss the same shot twice. Let's see if Joyce can follow that old standby. And the referees are going to come over to the bench and talk about who that is exactly and make sure they got all their foul counts right. Now, just all procedural stuff here for a game with 3.5 seconds left and a four-point margin between the two teams.
Joyce sets up again. Good again. 58-53 Bishop Garrigan. Inbound to Madden. 3 seconds, 2 seconds. Half-court heave by Madden. It's no good. The North Union Warriors are undefeated no more as Bishop Garrigan comes out on the road and they shock North Union of a 58-53 victory. The Warriors battled back at the end of the game. They had a chance to tie it, but ultimately Bishop Garrigan prevails in this highly contested back-and-forth rivalry matchup. 58-53. Did that game live up to the hype or what?
Yeah, super fun contest between these two games. And Tyler, we get to watch this one again, do we not?
Yes, we do. Later on this season in late January,
that time
at the Bishop Garrigan Gym.
That is going to be a matchup down there. These two teams, they always seem to win on their home court. Maybe this year is the year where each team can win one on the opponent's court. But Bishop Garrigan gets round one against North Union. Yeah, great contest between these two teams. Dynamite, speed, athleticism, very fun basketball game. Great job by both coaching staffs. Calling good plays at the right times. Just a great contest here relatively early in the season before Christmas.
Well, the four-game winning streak by the home teams in this series is over. The past two seasons, these teams have split. The home teams won both of the matchups, but Garrigan has their first win inside of this gymnasium in a couple of years after really having some dark times in this gym the past couple of seasons. So that is an early season-defining win for Bishop Garrigan. The Golden Bears now 4-3 on the season, and they are 3-2 in top of Iowa West play. The North Union Warriors, they dropped to 7-1. They are 4-1 in the conference, and the possible undefeated matchup against Lake Mills on Tuesday they were looking ahead to will no longer be an undefeated matchup, but likely still be a very good one of that. We'll step aside for a timeout. We'll wrap it up with some final stats after this on 92.7 KLGA.
High school sports on Hometown and Home Country Radio are brought to you by these fine sports club members.
Farmer State Bank is proud to be part of our community. Offices in Algona, Whittemore, and West Bend.
Stroman Dental, giving you something to smile about.
Bill's Auto and Truck Repair. Service is the difference.
Trend Salon, your complete family hair salon. It's all about you.
Oakcrest Funeral Services, celebrating a life lived.
Algona Frame and Auto Body, we meet by accident.
Water Connection, from softeners to bottled water and service, call 295-SOFT.
Algona Pizza Ranch, there's so much to love.
Cotton Grave Farm Management and Land Realty in downtown Algona, trusted for farmland service needs since 1960.
Sponsoring this broadcast on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
B Bishop Garrigan hands North Union their first loss of the season. Final score 58-53 in the boys matchup. The boys went first tonight. The ladies are coming up in just under 15 minutes. But right now, we'll look at a couple final numbers for the boys game. The scoring by quarter looked like this. North Union had a 19-16 advantage after one. Bishop Garrigan had a 10-9 scoring advantage in the second quarter as the Warriors led 28-26 at half. The third quarter turned everything around. Bishop Garrigan had a 19-11 advantage in the third. They went up 45-39 going to the fourth. Then in the final quarter, North Union had a 14-13 scoring advantage, but that does not tell the whole story, and we'll get to that whole story in a second. Individual scoring looked like this. The leaders for North Union are Preston Gurdett with 13 points, Aiden Wastrom of 12, Grady Madden with 9, and Kyan Jones and Cody Ermeter 8 apiece. For Bishop Garrigan, Carter Schwab had 16, Michael Joyce had 14, Justin Bauer had 10, and Logan Nemers had 8. And I'll start here, Beanie. On the nights where Schwab and Joyce have both had good games, Garrigan has won. Simple as that. The teams that have beaten Garrigan have forced one of them to have an off night. Both Schwab and Joyce really stepped up. The two young guards coming up with some big plays for Bishop Garrigan in this win.
Yeah, if you were playing against Garrigan, you could try to do some sort of junk defense and try to stop them, but they're both such threats to score. You got to play them straight or they're going to make you suffer. But yeah, Tyler, Schwab and Joyce can really do a lot of different things offensively. They can shoot outside. They drive the ball hard to the basket. Yeah, they're just really, really tough backcourt here for Bishop Garrigan. And they're young. You just got a sophomore and a freshman back there, so that's going to be fun to see those guys develop. But I think Tyler Garrigan really won that game inside tonight. North Union showed it at times, just brilliant passing interiorly. And Garrigan coaching staff worked different post players in all night. You saw Amari Thomas, Drew Muller, Nick Lear, and Logan Nemers all do significant minutes down low, and they played very good defense. And that height, that shot-blocking presence of the Bishop Garrigan big men, I think really took North Union out of their regular dominance offensively. They just couldn't pass the balls effectively. Garrigan went with that zone all night, kind of gave them fits, and I don't think the North Union offense really was ever in sync tonight.
That is 100% correct, in my opinion. I really think North Union looked a little hesitant on offense tonight. Garrigan mixed in that 3-2 zone, a little 2-3 as well. And, you know, what makes North Union so good is how good they are passing the ball. I mean, how many times have we seen throughout the career where Kyan Jones drives in, he sucks in the whole defense, and then drops it off to Ermeter or Wastrom for a wide-open two? That was non-existent tonight. Garrigan said, that is not how we're going to lose tonight. If we're going to lose, it's going to be the 15-footers. It's going to be the three-point shots. And, boy, North Union nearly did steal the end of a three-point shot. But, ultimately, it was a great defensive game plan tonight for the Golden Bears against North Union team that thrives off their passing game setting things up.
Yeah, and I didn't think we'd be talking about defense after the game. I thought, if anything, these teams are going to have a run-out track meet where the score is something like 75-80 or something like that. But neither team got the track meet going fully, but Garrigan made a nice little run there towards the end of the third quarter where a little spurt happened where they put up 9 points real quick, and that really changed the dynamic of the game, put the pressure on North Union all throughout that fourth quarter. They almost pulled it off. Huge shot by Gardett there, nailing that three-pointer to cut it to one, but Garrigan iced it down the stretch. Boy, North Union had a great look to tie up the game. Madden in the corner, just off the mark, and that can be that pressure. But that's what both these teams gained from this game here earlier in the season. Now they both have a high-pressure, intense environment under their belt. Garrigan will probably have another one in their gym tomorrow against Algona High. That's always a hotly contested contest, a fun one for sure. And North Union, the ceiling is really high for both these teams, but I would say Garrigan got a little bit higher of a ceiling because they're just starting to put it together. And you can see that tonight. They played 9 guys, and all of them contributed. You know, like that's a pretty good luxury for the Garrigan coaching staff. It's a great problem to have, is that you have all this talent. And, yeah, Garrigan can really put together something special, as North Union kind of already has. Like, they're already a really good team. Garrigan just becoming a really good team.
Yes. And I think coming out of this game, too, both teams will say, we need to play better in end-of-game situations. If you look at Bishop Garrigan, they had 2 late turnovers where all they needed to do was hold on to the ball and get fouled. They missed 6 free throws in a row. There were some really sloppy moments for Bishop Garrigan in the final few minutes, and it didn't matter because they held on. And, you know, they gave up a 3-point ball to the North Union to cut the game to 1 at one point. Then they hit a couple free throws late. They got it back, and they kind of staved off that last 3-point attempt by Madden. And, you know, I think for North Union, you can kind of say the same thing, too. You know, end of game, I thought – I actually, even though they lost, I thought North Union actually did a little better in the end of game situation than Garrigan did this time around. But there was a point in that fourth quarter where things just kind of slipped a little bit for the Warriors. All of a sudden, you look up, Garrigan's up by 7, and that was a deficit too much to overcome on a great defensive night for the Golden Bears.
Yeah, totally right, Tyler. Now, this is a big conference game. This kind of changes the dynamic of the conference. You know, going in, you look at Lake Mills, top of the conference, and you think, well, maybe North Union has a chance to knock off Lake Mills. Then Garrigan comes in and knocks off North Union tonight. And kind of changes the whole prediction for the rest of the season. Like, after tonight, Tyler, do you think either of these teams might get to the point where they can knock off the Bulldogs from Lake Mills?
Boy, it's possible. But like I said, when Bishop Garrigan played Lake Mills, I will believe Lake Mills will lose a conference game when I see them lose a conference game. I do think these two teams have the best chance of doing it. Garrigan's already 0-1. North Union does get their chance on Tuesday, but I do think Warriors have some adjustments to make, because if I'm Coach Menke at Lake Mills, I'm looking at this film and saying, oh, that's how you do it.
Oh, yeah, that's the great film here for Coach Menke at Lake Mills. But boy, North Union, they're going to go into that Lake Mills game on Tuesday after a tournament tomorrow and this hard game tonight. They're gonna be waiting for that Christmas break to get some rest.
Well, you know, it's going to be a great season for North Union, ladies and gents. I mean, you could argue this was one of their worst games of the season, and they still nearly beat Bishop Garrigan tonight. Final score 58-53. But ultimately, this is kind of a sloppy early season game. A lot of turnovers on both sides, but back and forth, gritty, hard fought. And I would imagine we'll see an even better game, maybe more cleanly played, when these two teams match up at Garrigan High School coming up in January.
Oh, yeah. Coaches love to use the cliche these days of you got to overcome adversity. And Coach Fisher and the Warriors definitely had that tonight. They had several of their best players on the bench for significant chunks of the game with foul trouble. Gerdet was out for a lot of the game, and he came into ice that big three at the end. Lostrom had to sit a lot, so they were playing. They can go deep as well. They played 8 players tonight, and all very successfully. But they had to overcome some adversity tonight with guys on the bench that they didn't plan on being on the bench.
Well, that will wrap it up for the boys' game, but we still have the girls' game coming up. As in the boys' game, Bishop Garrigan defeats North Union 58-53. We'll step aside for a timeout and hear from North Union girls' basketball coach Merle Tagus. It's on the way on KLGA 92.7 and at the Elgwater Radio YouTube stream.
High school sports on Hometown and Home Country Radio are brought to you by these fine sports club members.
American Glass. For all your glass needs, think American.
Farm Bureau Financial Agents Dave Beich, Jason Brace, Daniel Folk, and Michael Toth.
Kemco Tires, they're all you need to know about tires and service.
Weikert Realtors, the 515 Agency, a fresh approach to real estate.
Billy Offerman, your State Farm insurance agent in Algona. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Iowa Lakes Community College, your community, your college.
Lusher Family Dentistry, serving your family since 1965 on Call Street in Algona.
BMC Advantage Insurance Services, insuring our neighbors for over 80 years.
Walker Chiropractic and Wellness, caring for Algona, Sway City, and the surrounding areas with chiropractic, nutritional, and physical therapy services.
All sponsors of this game broadcast.
Girls high school basketball action right now on Hometown Radio KLGA. So the North Union Warriors host the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears. And right now we're joined by North Union head coach Merle Tagus. Coach, first of all, we appreciate your time today. Let's start off earlier this week, as you guys picked up a couple of wins. First on Monday against Norfolk Kensett and on Tuesday against Belmont Clemmy. You know, in that Monday game, you guys trailed for a good period of time in the second half, but made a couple plays late there and ended up winning that one 52-47. What did you feel a couple factors were that put you over the top on Monday?
Well, I just... probably the big thing, we just stuck with it, I guess. No, I thought Norfolk played well. I mean, they played better than I thought they were going to play. They had a nice team, and they're making a lot of shots that first half. And second half, you know, we kind of slowed them down finally, and we just made enough plays at the end to get over the hump, you know. And probably our biggest thing is, we just got to stick with it, try to keep ourselves in games, and try to finish at the end when they're in those tight games.
And, Coach, on the second night of the back-to-back, you played on Tuesday against Belmont Clemmy, and that was a really dominant defensive performance as you won that game 47-20, specifically focusing on Addie Lamb as you guys held her in single digits. What did you feel a couple things that worked on her were?
Well, you know, we just made sure she didn't try to take as many looks away from me as you humanly could. You know, she's a very good ball player, and you don't want to give her open threes. And, you know, she likes to slice the middle of the defense, and we try to just basically just keep the ball out of her hands as much as possible and make her give it up some.
Coach, tonight you're getting back to top of Iowa West play, hosting the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears, and obviously a very different-looking Golden Bear team than the one of the past couple of seasons. As you look at them, what are a couple of things that jump out to you?
Well, you know, they're a quick team. They added a freshman post player, you know, just complimenting their guards and their capacious girl. And, they're doing a good job. They shoot well, and, you know, they're quick. And, you know, I see they're shooting the free throw line well. And, you know, basically just got to keep as many shooters covered up as much as possible. But I think their quickness is definitely helping them.
Coach, along those same lines, talking about keeping those shooters covered up. They're a team that's going to shoot a lot of three-pointers, and they've done it pretty well so far this season. So what are a couple of things that you're focusing on as you try to really focus on defending that three-point line?
Well, you just got to, you know, got to take some angles and make sure that they're not getting open looks. And, you know, sometimes if you overhelp, sometimes, you know, you give teams too many open threes. So we just try to basically keep them covered up the best we can. They're going to get some shots off guaranteed, obviously, And, you know, they got some inside presence, and, you know, I think, you know, the Pacious, obviously, she rebounds very well and shoots well, too. So I think when they miss some shots, you know, they crash the boards, and there's a lot of things we got to do to keep them under control the best we can.
And, Coach, obviously something that all coaches are kind of dealing with this time of year is the fact that winter break is right around the corner. You have the final couple of basketball games and final couple of days of school before that arrives. How are you dealing with that as far as the team's concerned, just making sure that things are dialed in right before winter break and getting done in both practice and the games?
Well, a lot of us, you know, since we've had so many new girls this year, we're just trying to get everybody in the right positions. I think we've slowly getting where girls are comfortable and doing things that we're comfortable with, and you know, just getting kids with the shots that we feel that they are comfortable with, and that's probably the biggest thing. I think we're slowly improving on that, so I think our focus has stayed decent, and probably the hardest thing for us the last couple of weeks, we've had a lot of back-to-back games, so you know, we've just been trying to keep kids rested and healthy, and just trying to survive. You know, we play tonight and we play tomorrow night. We play tomorrow afternoon right away again, and a lot of that kind of stuff. That's probably the hardest part right now.
Coach, as we wrap up, what do you feel a couple of the biggest deciding factors for tonight's game are going to be?
Well, we want to cover the three-point line the best we can and try to, you know, make sure they're not just getting wide open threes. And, you know, I think we got to do a little better job on the boards. I think us personally, we've just been maybe not quite good enough on the boards. And, you know, they rebound well, and we got to make sure we get the rebounds as many as we can and try to keep them off the boards too. And then, you know, I still think a lot of it's some transition D. You know, we need to get back in transition. We need to get out in transition. And they do the same thing. They want to push the ball and they want to get back. And, you know, the better jobs teams do at that, you know, make teams run their offense and stuff like that.
Coach, we appreciate your time today and wish you best of luck for tonight's game.
Yeah, thank you.
That is North Union basketball coach Merle Takis here on Hometown Radio KLGA. We'll step aside right now for a timeout, and we'll come back for more pregame coverage next as we get set for tip-off between the North Union Warriors and the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears on Hometown Radio KLGA.
We've got more sports club members making this broadcast possible on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Reeves Wicked Good Bar and Grill. For wicked good food, drinks, and service, you gotta go to Reeves.
CB Grain Solutions, satisfaction guaranteed.
New Way K&H Co-op, delivering exceptional value through knowledge and innovation.
Dump It, they do the dirty work so you don't have to.
Albert Electric, flip the switch to Albert Electric.
Grassmasters, growing satisfied customers.
Greg Penning and Company, certified public accountants, where everyone counts.
Yemlin Builders and Apartments, quality apartments for rent, beauty and craftsmanship that will never go out of style.
Daylight Donuts, open early with delicious donuts and great coffee.
All sponsors of this game broadcast.
Time to meet the starting lineup for the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears.
Grayson Eastman, freshman, number 14.
Inside to Eastman. Eastman puts it up, but she puts it in.
Zoe Montag, junior, number 22.
Garrigan of a steal. Here comes the transition. A sidestep by Montag in the lay-in. Zoe Montag is going crazy right now, and Garrigan's up 81-38.
Seisha Olish, sophomore, number 24.
Capacious hangs and passes to the left wing. Olish for retry, and she swished it again. Let Seisha Olish shoot it.
Emmy Bartolo, sophomore, number 10.
Cross-court feed over to Bartolo. Catches, fires, rattles in a three-pointer.
Abby Capacious, senior, number 21.
A long pass inside to the cutting Capacious. Jumps, catches, finishes on the reverse.
Tip-off of your game is coming up next on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
The Bishop Garrigan girls lineup under head coach Brandon Schwamm. And yes, we have the girls game going second tonight as the North Union boys basketball team is playing at the Baumgars Invitational at 10 o'clock tomorrow morning. So they wanted the early game tonight. We're flipping around the boys and girls game. And boy, what a girls matchup tonight. The 6-1 Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears against the 5-2 North Union Warriors. Golden Bears are 4-0 in the conference. North Union 3-1 in the conference. And the Golden Bears have defeated North Union 9 straight times. Obviously a different looking Golden Bear team coming into tonight's game though. For the Warriors under head coach Merle Tagus, they will have the freshman Ainsley Ulrich, the senior Libby Stevens, the junior Ava Steinberger, the senior Olivia Merrill, and the senior Naomi Jones in their starting lineup. Golden Bears wearing the road golds tonight as they are being introduced on the floor right now. And of course, here at North Union High School, the drums are going to start playing in the background, the crowd's going to get into it, and the Warrior lineup is going to be introduced, one of the better intros in the conference. And Beanie, always a tough place to play. We talked about this during the boys' game, but the girls got to get used to it too. Crowd right on top of you, not much space in the out-of-bounds area. Takes a minute to adjust to.
Yeah, they got a stage across the way from where we're sitting, and the students are already hanging their legs off the edge, and during the contest, those students will be up on their feet right on top of you if you're a guard that dares to go to that student den over there of Warrior fans. The pep band is over there right now. They played the anthem really nicely earlier up here at North Union. And boy, yeah, you're not wrong. The crowd, the students, everything, it's on top of you here. And there is no room. Cheerleaders are crammed in there against the bench. It's fun, Tyler. It's exciting atmosphere.
So incredibly exciting atmosphere for the Golden Bears and the Warriors as North Union wears their home white uniforms with the North, the number underneath it, and then the Union below the number. It's white uniforms with green numbering and lettering on the front and back. Bishop Garrigan, as you said, in the road gold, so the black lettering and numbering, the Garrigan across the front and the numbers across the back, the black stripes down the side. Normal starting five for Bishop Garrigan as they will wait for North Union to exit from their final timeout. Golden Bears last season got one of their tougher games here at this very gym, beating North Union 63-49 in that one. Also had a big win at home during last year's season, 71-26, as the Golden Bears have won 9 straight against the Warriors. At midcourt, Abby Capacious against Olivia Merrill. Merrill wins the tip, gets it to Steinberger, and we are underway as North Union heads from left to right on the radio dial. Libby Stevens will handle the rock for North Union, heads right against Aulish, flips down to the baseline, intercepted by Eastman for an early turnover.
A design play, Garrigan saw that one coming, and there's an early foul on Naomi Jones, just accidental. She tried to come over and pressure Aulish against the sideline, but got the hips into her and knocks her out of bounds. Quick pickup by Jones, who is a pivotal part of this North Union team.
Well, there were a lot of fouls and a lot of travels called in the boys' game, and these are the same officials, obviously, as Aulish tees up a left-wing three-point ball off the heel, no good, and Montag grabs the offensive board. There were 3 gold jerseys surrounding that basketball as the pass goes into Eastman. Nice underhanded give to Capacious, who sails in for the 2.
Oh, great offense. Capacious with the first 2 of the game to get the scoring started. Garrigan is pressing. They press a lot this year.
Stevens, the 5'7 senior, second team all-conference selection last season, heads right, guarded by Sasha Aulish. Dribbles between the legs and brings it back towards the top of the key. Looks and bounces it over to Steinberger. 1 minute gone here in quarter number 1 as Ulrich gets to the foul line. Ulrich, tough jumper over Bartolo. It misses. It deflects towards the far side. Merrill tracks it down. Tiptoes. She got her arm on the wall trying to balance. Her feet were in bounds. Her arm was on the wall, and the referees only saw the arm late, but they call it out of bounds.
Merrill's all smiles as she heads back up the floor. She held the sideline like a professional wide receiver in the NFL, but she put her arm out and used the wall.
But that is objectively funny as the ball is knocked out of bounds. The referees were looking at her feet to see if her feet were still in bounds. Then they looked up and said, oh, your hand's on the wall. Wait a minute. That's not allowed.
Well, and then everyone had to think about, well, wait a minute. Is that in the rule book? Maybe you can touch the wall.
Yeah, what are the ground rules here? As Capacious catches the inbounds, she put it in, and the foul. Oh, Capacious shielded off the defender, and she gets a chance for a 3-point play.
Boy, Capacious pumped up. She was quiet at school today. She must be focused in on tonight's contest between her and the Warriors, she being the senior on the team, along with Elena Casey. And here she goes for the free throw.
Capacious tees it up quickly, and the free throw rattles and drops. Bishop Garrigan scores the first 5 points of the ball game as the full court press comes in. Stevens catches, shadows by Aulish in the backcourt. Here comes the screen by Merrill. That'll free Stevens up to get it across the timeline. Stevens drifts towards the right, stops the foul line, and underhints to Merrill. Out to the right side to Jones. Jones, a first-team all-conference selection last year, launches on the three, swirls out of the cup, no good. Merrill hustles for the rebounds and beats Eastman to it. Golden Bears try to trap in the corner, but Merrill passed out to Ulrich. Ulrich, deep tray, and way too strong off the glass as Capacious make that Aulish grabs the board. 5-0 Bishop Garrigan. Here's Aulish giving to Capacious. It's through the hands of Jones and out of bounds. That pass was off target by Aulish, but Jones couldn't collect it.
One thing Garrigan does so well on defense is communicate. They closed that trap in the corner a second ago with such confidence and great communication. That's what makes them such a solid defensive team, and their defense has really amped up lately.
Aulish from the near side, lobs it all the way up top to Montag, catches over the top of Ulrich as the Bishop Garrigan Jr. dribbles between the legs. Montag drives in, dumps to Eastman. They will wave it off, a push by North Union. Eastman would have been wide open for a layup, so that might have been a decent foul early in this game, but yeah. Already three on North Union.
Montag would have probably preferred to have the assist there, but she draws the foul, and that could become a factor in this game as North Union already has three fouls here. And I don't think they go as deep as Garrigan does.
Shaylee Wallers checks into the ball game. The freshman is one of two Warriors who have played all seven games off the bench. The flip over to the right to Montag. Montag, free ball on the way, too strong. Capacious sails in for the board. Capacious is in traffic, kicks it out to Bartolo, rotates to Montag, same spot. A little bit too strong on the three-point shot as Montag goes over two on that possession. Ulrich out quickly for North Union. Ulrich driving down the lane, scooping up the layup, left it short. Capacious had the rebound briefly. It got tipped to Ulrich, but a foul going against North Union once again.
Wow, Ulrich is gonna get dinged for that foul. I thought they were, it's going to be called on Merrill. No, I'm sorry. Yeah, it is on Olivia Merrill. That'll be her first foul, I'm sorry. Boy, it was a battle for the rebound there. Calling it tight here, not letting these girls battle very hard down low.
Four fouls by North Union just over 2 minutes into the game. Garrigan is already one away from the bonus. Aulish passes to Capacious, open in the corner for a catch-and-shoot tray. Three-pointer is short. Capacious got her own miss back, follows it up, and Capacious draws the foul. That is already number five on North Union, and Abby Capacious is already wreaking havoc on the glass.
Yeah, that's three rebounds already in the game for Capacious, who just crossed 600 rebounds in the last contest, got a nice little banner for 600 rebounds, and I said, well, we're just going to have to do this again when you get 700 rebounds, because she's aiming for that for sure this season.
It might not be too far away as Capacious swishes the first free throw, but Beanie, back to a couple minutes ago, you talked about North Union and their bench. That has been a question mark this season. In three of the last four games, North Union has gotten 0 points off their bench, so that will likely have to change tonight for the Warriors to win as Capacious knocks down the free throw. She has all 7 points, and it's 7-0 Garrigan. Wallers in the backcourt gets it off to Stevens. Stevens will bring it across the timeline, guarded by Sasha Aulish. The screen by Merrill, the pass over to Walters, tees up a three-point ball, left it short. Rebound is tracked down by Montag, had it briefly, and a foul
and
by North Union.
Foul.
Steinberger looks to grab the left shoulder of Montag that time as Steinberger picks up her first and North Union's sixth.
And here goes Garrigan to shoot free throws with 5 minutes and 15 seconds left to go in the first period. Garrigan is going to be shooting free throws, which they do very well.
Bishop Garrigan so far this season for the free throw line, 71.1%. That is number two in the top of Iowa West, as Zoe Montag herself, 6 of 8 at the foul line this season. She doesn't take a lot of free throws just because about 65% of her shots come from three-point range, as she'll can the first free throw and make it 8-0 Garrigan.
Boy, the Bishop Garrigan defense has just been swarming. They press, but the press has not created much turnovers. But when they get in that half court, they are coming at you.
Montag knocks down the free throw, 9-0 Bishop Garrigan. Jones back into the ball game, navigating the press, gets it across the court to Stevens. Stevens brings the ball near side against Emmy Bartolo this time. Stevens drives in, gets turned back out by Bartolo. She flings it over to Ulrich. Ainsley Ulrich shot 2 of 18 against Belmont Clemmie Tuesday, trying to bounce back as she'll float. A foul before the shot, the push called against Bishop Garrigan as the foul picked up by Sasha Aulish.
Ulrich doing a nice drive against Aulish. Aulish working hard. But excellent offensive moves.
Ball gets into the high post to Merrill. Down to the right corner to Stevens with 4:58 on the clock. 9-0 Bishop Garrigan. Stevens turns her back to the bucket. It's Capacious, pesters on defense. Now it's Jones down the lane. The floater off the window. No good. Pops out of the cup. Ball knocked out of bounds. Last touched by Bishop Garrigan.
But the best look that North Union's had so far offensively. Jones with a great drive down the middle of the lane. Just too hard off the glass. They've got a lid on their basket.
Into Merrill. Merrill to the right corner to Stevens. Stevens slicing in, gives it right back to Merrill. Merrill keeping the ball safe, throws it over the head of Stevens and out of bounds.
Boy, Stevens is a very talented ball handler. Coach Tiggins wants a timeout. Try to set up something. They got to get the ice broken on their scoreboard.
The first time out of the game called by North Union, it's 9-0 Bishop Garrigan. And that's the big concern when you come to North Union, is that you come out slow on the road and you spot the Warriors a 9-0 lead. Garrigan has withstood the early energy of the crowd. They've actually made the crowd quite quiet here the way they've gotten North Union in foul trouble. They've gotten to the free throw line. And now North Union, they're going to have to find a way to build some momentum of their own. Maybe it comes from the three-point ball. Whether it comes from the three-point ball or not, though, they've got to start finding some open looks against the Garrigan defense, which has been outstanding so far.
Yeah, you bet. In the last minute, they had a few good looks at the basket. And just like we had in the boys' game, they're just cold. The North Union boys went on a stretch where they couldn't find a bucket, and the girls are starting off their contest. But like you said, Tyler, this foul trouble really keeping them at bay here. With 4 minutes and 42 seconds, they already have five fouls.
Bishop Garrigan with the basketball right now as Alish has it. Alish flings it over to Montag. Had a brief second to shoot it, but fought better of it as Alish gets the basketball back. Sasha Alish averaging 15.6 points per game, threads it to Eastman. Eastman sets it in for two more.
It was a good job by Alish, taking one extra dribble to get a little deeper and get a better angle to make that pass.
Sasha Alish, 3.6 assists per game for Bishop Garrigan as Jones has it down in the right corner for North Union. Now Stevens on the wing. Fought about three, gave it off to Jones instead. Into the post to Merrill. Spins against Eastman. Puts it up, and Eastman got a little arm that time as she had good positioning on defense, but got the arm of Merrill as the North Union senior shoots too.
Good move by Merrill. Good strong post up. She had Eastman on her hip. Eastman is laughing right now. She's looking at her coach. Eastman, just a freshman, and she plays with all the excitement and giddiness you'd expect of a freshman. She's really improving game by game. Just becomes a better post player.
Merrill misses the first free throw right. The second one off the heel, no good. And Montag has the rebound. Halfway through the first quarter, and North Union is still 0 for the game so far. Merrill coming off a nice game against Belmont Clemias. A deep three by Alish, way short. Capacious, another cleanup in the lay-in.
Easiest rebound Capacious has ever gotten. Just comes right off the front of the rim, right into the breadbasket. She goes back up for a deuce. Naomi Jones is saying, hey, team, they are pressing hard. You got to come up and help. And North Union, boy, everything going for the Bears and against the Warriors here, as they couldn't even get a bucket on a wide-open free throw. And no one's guarding you on the free throws, Tyler.
Steinberger checks out. Walters checks back in. The referee tells Capacious not to cross over the baseline defending the inbounds pass as Orrick passes away from the trap, gets back to Stevens. Stevens works the baseline, weaves away from Capacious toward the far side. They double-team Stevens. She's in trouble. Ball's on the floor. And time is running out. That's 10 seconds unless there's a timeout. No timeout call by North Union. That's got to be a 10-second call.
Boy, Capacious, credit her. And two different teammates that Capacious worked together with to form two really tight traps. The Garrigan will throw different presses at you. That was their trapping press. They trapped early, and then they trapped secondarily. Gets the call.
Zoe Montag on the right wing for Bishop Garrigan. 3.5 minutes left in the first. Capacious down in the right corner right now. She leads the way with 9 points. Montag down the lane. Left-handed floater in and out. Rebound pops loose, and it's picked up along the far side of the court by Walters. Walters, the freshman, bobs it up over the head of Stevens. It's going out of bounds, and it is going back to Bishop Garrigan.
Yeah, they were trying a fast break there. If you can get a fast break, you don't have to worry about the press, but she threw it over the top to nobody.
If you get a fast break, sometimes you can get an easy bucket out of that when the Garrigan defense doesn't have time to get set. But things not going North Union's way as Montag gets the pass underneath to Eastman. Eastman's sidearm throw out to Alish goes out of bounds, and it was not touched as North Union gets it back.
Eastman was right against the out-of-bounds line and tried to desperately throw it to Alish, threw it wide. Here comes some speed.
Stevens works her way into the front court, dribbles around Merrill. Merrill setting a screen in the high post. Stevens sidestepped into a three-point ball and missed it left. Capacious stays away, and the ball goes out of bounds.
Well, Capacious just kept everyone away and watched the ball go out of bounds. If she would have snagged it, it'd be another rebound.
That's right. Capacious is more about the team than the individual stats, but she may be approaching a double-double in the first half before it even comes to an end because she's been all over the glass tonight and already has 9 points. Capacious catches just out of the lane. Quick pass out to Montag. Now Bartolo top of the key. Center of the paint, Eastman. Works around Merrill. Off the window, tough shot, no good. And here comes North Union off the rebound. Stevens is the front court. Alish quickly picks her up on defense with 2:30 left in the first quarter. 13-0 Bishop Garrigan. Merrill on the post. Eastman staying vertical. Merrill hooks around. Left-handed shot, no good. Got her miss back. And she shuffled the shoes. Couldn't keep that pivot hook stationary. She turns it over.
Yeah, we should probably give note to Coach Schwab here. Nice job of his defense player so far, but also good job to the coach here because he's guarding Stevens with Sasha Alish wherever she goes, and just it is making it miserable for Stevens to get the North Union offense going.
Timeout called by Coach Schwab. We'll keep it right here of 2:20 on the clock. And I'll make this point about Coach Schwab, too. This is a prove-it year for the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears with no Molly Joyce and Audie Crooks. This is a prove-it year for Coach Schwab as well. I think he's done a fantastic job for Bishop Garrigan the past several years. And a lot of people may look and say, well, he had the star players. How hard can it be? But I think what you're seeing right now, what he's doing tonight and the way he's gotten the team off to a 6-1 start, it starts with the head coach and it kind of goes down to the players as well.
Yeah, and they really buy into everything Coach Schwab teaches them. And, you know, you see Eastman there just a moment ago doing a really nice post move. That's not something, you know, that's practice. They really work on those skills at practice. But, you know, obviously stars going off to college, Audie Crooks, Molly Joyce, and don't forget about Ashlyn Hovey was another senior they lost last year, too. But it's certainly not like the cupboard was bare. I mean, he's bringing back his guards. Alish and Bartolo played a ton last year. Eastman, a freshman coming in, is very good. Zoe Montag, the junior, she's very good. And you got Reagan Murphy, a senior, Capacious, a senior, Elena Cates come back. I mean, he's got a nice cupboard of players to choose from here. So, but well said. He's going to have to definitely coach differently than he has the past couple.
Yeah, the attention to detail always great for Coach Schwab as Bishop Garrigan has the ball coming out of the timeout. 2:14 left in the first quarter. Out to Alish. Deep tray, and she missed it left and short as Merrill picks up the rebound for North Union. Jones up quickly, finds Stevens. Stevens wide open, and she lays it in. Bartolo had the late contest, but Stevens gets North Union on the board at the 2-minute mark.
Whew, the ice is broken on that basket. Boy, it's good to see North Union get a bucket.
First one coming 6 minutes in. Stevens averaging just under 10 points per game so far this season. And she is the first two for North Union. 13-2, Bishop Garrigan here in the North Union High School Gymnasium as Montag handles the rock, gives it to Bartolo. Contested three on the way, and she rattles it in! Emmy Bartolo from downtown.
Oh, they will shoot three after three after three, playing those percentages.
Emmy Bartolo has been a 43.6% three-point shooter this year. That is nearly automatic as Ulrich tries to hook it up and under, and she shuffled the shoes. Ulrich can't believe it, but that'll be a turnover by North Union.
Ulrich says she kept her pivot foot. So does Coach Tigges. The referee disagrees, and Coach Tigges then nods his head in agreement as here comes Capacious against a little North Union pressure. They get a hand, and they get a turnover.
They force the turnover. Walters gets it down to Stevens. Stevens off the window, and there's two more.
4 points, 16-4, Garrigan. Alish at the ball, half court.
Garrigan quickly gets it across the press. This time is Alish. Has it 107 on the clock. Finds the curling Capacious. Left of the lane. Shoots over Merrill and drops it in. 11 points by Abby Capacious as it's 18-4 Bishop Garrigan. Running the floor, Jones. Jones slicing in. Left the layup short. And Eastman forces a one and done. 53 seconds left in the quarter as Bishop Garrigan has the basketball. Eastman, great job staying vertical on that last possession. Alish wanting to drive. Flips it into the corner to Capacious. Keeps her eyes up as she surveys the defense. Rotation around the perimeter for the Golden Bears of 40 seconds left in the first quarter. Montag top of the key. She'll drive. She'll jump and she'll pass up to Alish. Alish driving in. Ball stripped away by Stevens. Went right to Capacious. Capacious crashes in. Misses the layup. Got her on this back. 30 on the game clock. In the corner to Alish. Three-point ball. Too long. Rebound tipped. Eastman rips it away from Ulrich. 23 seconds left in the first quarter. Bartolo throws it high and it's out of bounds. And it was not tipped by North Union as the Warriors get it back.
Either way, they're about to call Eastman for 3 seconds in the lane. The official blew at the same time as the ball went out of bounds. Garrigan setting up their press. Garrigan really dominating the glass there.
North Union breaks the press. Jones flies to the bucket, and it rolls in on the layup. Jones is on the scoreboard, and it's 18-6. Now 12 seconds left in the quarter. 10 seconds, Capacious in the backcourt, passes away from a double team. 7 seconds, Bartolo wide open, look for three, and she buries it! Emmy Bartolo with 3 seconds left in the quarter. Warriors inbound the ball to Jones. Jones with half a second, and she will not get a shot off before the end of the first quarter. Emmy Bartolo hits a couple of late three-point balls, and Bishop Garrigan roars out of the gates here at North Union High School. It's Bishop Garrigan 21 and North Union 6 on KLGA 92.7 FM.
We've got more Sports Club members making this broadcast possible on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Algona Livestock, sales every Monday.
Countryside Barbecue Sauce, two sauces for all seasons.
Farm and Home Services, view their listings at farmhomeservices.com.
Holmes Animal Clinic, animals large and small, they love them all.
Style Salon, your salon in Algona, create yourself.
Dance Connection and Tumbling by Michelle. Passionate about teaching, creative about dance. Visit their studio or danceconnectionbymichelle.com.
TAFE Wellness Center in Algona and Armstrong. Keeping athletes in the game with chiropractic care. Take charge of your health.
SignWorks for all of your signage needs, as well as printed shirts, caps, and jackets. Stop in or call 295-9544.
Down-to-earth tree service, your local Algona tree service.
Sports Club members bringing you this game.
Bishop Garrigan in quarter number one as the Golden Bears grab a 21-6 lead over the North Union Warriors. North Union did not get their first bucket until 2 minutes left in the first quarter as Bishop Garrigan has the ball to start the second. Beanie, North Union got in some major foul trouble in the first quarter, and that really changed the way they played defense.
Yeah, and they were kind of playing out of their rhythm. Once they got that lid off the hoop, they scored 6 points in a flurry, and they can run the floor very well.
Eastman dives down the lane. Shot blocked by Steinberger. North Union with the rejection, and now here comes Libby Stevens across the North Union logo at midcourt. Stevens weaves across the foul line, drives in left of the bucket, flips it up and in. That ball got tipped on the way up, and it still went through.
Yeah, with her left hand, she did a little scoop layup. Impressive drive by Stevens. Here comes Capacious against her.
6 of 8 points go to Stevens so far for North Union. Bartolo extra pass to Montag. Corner pocket three, pops in and out of the cup, and Jones boxes out for the rebound. Here comes Naomi Jones, 12.3 points per game so far this season. Had a 15-point, 11-rebound double-double against Belmont Clemmie Tuesday, but she travels and turns it over.
Well, she ran into her own player. It caused her to shuffle her feet. Both players kind of frustrated. One apologizes to the other. Bartolo bringing it up against the press.
Bartolo flips it ahead to Capacious, sprinting it past the press. Now down to the left to Aulish. 7:09 on the clock, quarter number two. Aulish finds Capacious in the corner as Abby Capacious has 11. Eastman in the post, working against Steinberger. Goes all the way to the right. Steinberger blocks, but this time a foul. She got arm as well, and two free throws coming from Eastman.
Eastman gets that ball and goes to work with her post moves. You can tell she's put in a lot of time in the gym working on those moves. Has a really nice job drop-stepping to her left and going up off the glass. Tyler, you're way too young to know six-on-six basketball, but Eastman is the total prototype for someone in six-on-six that would score a lot of points.
Yeah, six-on-six basketball. If you go back and watch some of the old videos of state basketball when it was six-on-six, it's a different sport, honestly, but it is very intriguing to watch as the score is 22-8. As Bishop Garrigan has Eastman to 3 points right now. 1 minute gone in quarter number two. Golden Bears looking for their 10th straight win against the Warriors as a foul line jumper by Walters. Knuckles off the rim and drops through.
Nice shot there by North Union. They're up to 10. It's 22-10. They're cutting into that lead a little bit as Capacious goes against the press, and they're going to call a timeout. The official says perhaps he made a mistake. Coach Schwab is laughing. Coach Tiggis doing the same. The official come over and said, my fault there. I think it must have been some sort of inadvertent whistle. Or he thought maybe Capacious double dribbled, but she didn't. And a good remedy is just say take it out of bounds.
Yeah, inadvertent whistle play on Capacious, floater from the lane. It knuckles on the rim and it bounces in. Yeah, Coach Schwab's eyes were getting ready to pop out of his head as he saw that whistle coming in. 13 points by Capacious. Stevens drifts towards the far side of the court for North Union as Bishop Garrigan leads by 14 right now. Now it's Jones in the left corner, gives it back to Stevens. Stevens looking inside, Steinberger posting up against Eastman. Back outside to Jones. Jones on the drive. Jones in the lane. Shot swallowed up by Eastman. Out of bounds. Last touch by Eastman. This will pick up a block.
It's a good drive by Jones. She turns around and looks at Coach Tiggis and say, what am I supposed to do there? It was a good drive. It was another good defensive play there. And she'll get a foul call. She keeps doing that.
Reagan Murphy in for Graceland Eastman. Walther's three-point try misses right. And Capacious vacuums in another rebound. Abby Capacious flings it up ahead to Sasha Aulish. 5:59 on the clock as Aulish drives in. Aulish all the way to the hoop. Left the layup short, though. Steinberger had the late contest. Offensive board Garrigan as they rotate to Bartolo, but Bartolo travels off the pass.
Good rebound there by Reagan Murphy into the game for the first time here. She's another senior for Bishop Garrigan. Tyler, we're going to have this debate at halftime of how good of a team Bishop Garrigan would be if it was still 6-on-6. And I maintain they'd be fantastic. We'll have to discuss later.
Well, a 60-second timeout is called right now, so we'll discuss during the timeout and come back after this on 92.7 KLGA.
When you need cash on the go, there's no need to pay a surcharge fee with MoneyPass. Iowa State Bank is proud to be part of the MoneyPass network of surcharge-free ATMs found nationwide. Look for the green and blue MoneyPass symbol on over 32,000 ATMs across the nation. Or find an ATM near your vacation spot or travel destination at MoneyPass.com. MoneyPass, another way that Iowa State Bank helps people succeed. Member FDIC.
We'll be right back.
As we come back here on Hometown Radio KLGA, it's Bishop Garrigan 24 and at North Union 10. Warriors trying for their first win against Bishop Garrigan since December 14th of 2018 as they defeated the Golden Bears 39-36 that day. But right now, Golden Bears up by 14 off the big start. On the floor for Bishop Garrigan, it's going to be Murphy, Montag, Capacious, Bartolo, and Aulish. North Union's going to counter with Walters and Stevens, Jones and Steinberger, as well as Merrill. So Steinberger and Merrill will give the two bigs for the Warrior lineup, as it'll be Stevens handling the rock right now. Underhands it out to Jones. Jones, guarded by Abby Capacious, in the center of the paint to Merrill. Merrill hooks around Murphy. Merrill off the window, too strong. Rebound off of Montag's hands, shovels it back in, and got it to Capacious. That was a cardinal sin. You're not supposed to shovel it back in under your bucket, but Montag put that right on target to Capacious. Right wing three, Bartolo, and she hits again.
Oh, wow.
Emmy Bartolo cannot miss right now.
I believe you say Emmy is on fire. Wow, that was a deep one, too.
Bartolo averaging about 11.5 points per game. She already has 9 as Stevens drives in, but there was a foul before the drive as that one picked up by Bishop Garrigan, their first team foul of the quarter.
No, now Garrigan's in their straight up 2-3. They're playing a straight 2-3. They're not following Stevens around. Murphy, Montag, and Capacious down low.
Stevens bounces it into Jones with 5:15 left in the quarter. Aulish jumps in her face as the pass goes out to Walters. Walters in the post to Merrill, double teamed, but Capacious reached in there and fouled.
She just couldn't help it. Moth drawn to the flame. Merrill is a big body, and she's not going to let you reach around that easily. She had good position inside.
It'll be Stevens again. Stevens looking at 5:08 on the clock, threads it to Merrill. Merrill working against Montag. Montag does a great job staying vertical. Ball thrown away, Bartolo takes it. Here comes Aulish. Aulish slices past Walters, scoops it up, and oh, she traveled. Aulish put it in, but a travel. That was very nearly a beautiful defense to fast break sequence.
Yeah, that was a pretty, pretty move by Aulish. She brought the ball up over her head in a big roundhouse and got to the right-hand side of the hoop, but took one too many steps over there.
The freshman Ainsley Orrick checks back in for North Union as Stevens will take a break. Orrick will run point. Ainsley Orrick, leading scorer for North Union at 13.7 points per game, drives in, shoots the floater, and the wave it off, offensive foul.
They are going to call that on number 15 away from the ball.
Steinberger.
Steinberger must have been pushing to get in position for the rebound, and the official did not like it.
That is foul number 3 against Steinberger. North Union has seen 2 fouls called on Olivia Merrill and 2 fouls called on Naomi Jones.
I'll tell you, North Union, they're going in these streaks where they can score a flurry of points, then they go cold, and they're in one of their cold stretches right now. Bartolo is not cold. She is hot. She's going to have a heat check as she brings the ball up the floor. She might as well just launch it.
The 5'11 junior Hannah Nielsen off the bench. Murphy in the post. Nice pass to Eastman. Eastman trying to get it out to Montag. Warriors knock it away and force the turnover. Jones runs the floor. Jones attacks. Montag forces her wide. Great defense by Montag, and Capacious vacuums in another board. Abby Capacious, top of the key, gets it over to Montag. Montag in the post to Eastman. Eastman looking outside, underhands it to Murphy. Ball knocked away, and Jones grabs another turnover. Jones is to the front court. The North Union senior heads towards the right, now switches back to the left. Montag pokes the ball. Pass goes down to Merrill on the block. Out to Nielsen. It rolls off her leg. Bartolo with the hustle play, dives on top of it, but then she throws it right to Nielsen. Nielsen gets the bounce pass out to Merrill. 4:10 on the clock. Cross-court find of Ainsley Ulrich. Ulrich slicing into the lane. Hooks the right-hander up. Missed it right. Ball deflects. Nielsen shovels it in, but then it rolls back out as North Union turns it over.
Boy, what a hustle play Bartolo a second ago. Loose ball on the floor. I thought, North Union will get that back easily, but Bartolo just hustling over the ball. North Union set up for that 2-3, showing some frustration there. They worked real hard in that offensive series to come up empty.
Alyssa Hoagland has checked into the ball game for Bishop Garrigan as Reagan Murphy goes to the bench. And North Union has brought Libby Stevens back into the ball game. Emmy Bartolo will walk it across half court with 3:57 on the clock. Bartolo with 9 points tonight. Capacious with 13 for Bishop Garrigan. Cross court feed to Montag. Finds Capacious at the foul line. Capacious squares for a jumper, and it rattles off no good. Jones with another rebound. Well, Capacious was thinking about driving there, but they dared her to shoot that one as Stevens looks. Bounces it to Merrill, top of the key. Merrill gives it right back to Stevens, curling around at 3:35 on the clock. Stevens working to create space. Stevens driving in, gets left of Eastman, misses the layup. Ball rebounded by Merrill. Merrill puts it back up, and she spun it in. Nice play by Olivia Merrill.
Big, strong move against Eastman. And what a great drive by Stevens.
I'll tell you what, Garrigan interior defense, they're really forcing the North Union guards to drive wide and take tough angles on the layups as Montag squeezes the trigger on a three-pointer and knocks it down. 30-12, Bishop Garrigan.
Big shot by Montag. She's missed a few shots today. She just got to keep shooting, and then she finds the net.
Ainsley Orth pulls the trigger on a three, but she airballs it. It's heading out of bounds as Capacious stays away, and North Union will turn it over to Bishop Garrigan.
Well, there's another rebound, Abby, that you could have had.
That's two.
We'll keep track of the rebounds Abby doesn't get, since she gets so many other way.
Into Graceland Eastman, finds Capacious at the foul line, right to Montag. The head fake, the drive across the lane, the bounce pass to Eastman, into traffic, it rolls away, ball goes out of bounds, and they're hesitating here for a second. I think Garrigan's going to
They want to talk, make sure they know who got it. Eastman had the ball roll underneath her.
It'll be back to North Union. They'll say Eastman touched it last. That's what I thought initially, but the hesitation made me question that.
Well, this is a great challenge for Garrigan defensively because Jones and Stevens for North Union are dynamite guards.
Stevens hands the ball off to Steinberger. We'll check that to Nielsen. Jones top of the key, screen by Ulrich. Jones sidesteps, no space to release as she'll give it back to Stevens. 2.5 minutes left in the first half as Bishop Garrigan leads 30-12. Down the lane, Jones hangs, puts it off the glass, no good. Ball tipped away, offensive board. Merrill lost it out of bounds though. She shovels it back in and it goes to Emmy Bartolo. Keeps the dribble and gives it to Capacious.
Another hustle play for Bartolo. Boy, Naomi Jones, her frustration meter's got to be raising because she's had several wonderful drives to come up empty.
Pass over to Montag, right side, lets it fly, knocks down another three-pointer.
Oh, there's a smile by Montag. When you're cold, you're cold. When you're hot, you're hot. Bartolo and Montag heating it up so far in this quarter.
8 points by Montag. The number one ranked offense in the top of Iowa West, Bishop Garrigan, averaging 64.6 points per game. They have 33 right now before halftime. Merrill in the paint, scoops with a layup, missed it wildly. Ball tipped loose and taken by Capacious. The interior defense continues for the Golden Bears. Out to Hoagland, she'll catch and release a three-pointer. Pops out of the cup, no good, as Jones rebounds on the near side. Jones across the timeline, into the right corner. Jones driving in, got by Capacious and lays it in.
There she goes, another nice drive by Jones. Finally gets that basket to fall.
4 points by Jones so far tonight. 1:23 left in the first half. Eastman demanding the ball inside. Eastman against Merrill. Eastman in a sandwich. Passes out to nobody as the ball goes in between Montag and Hoagland.
Eastman puts her hands over her face. She was open. She called for the ball. She did everything right. And then when she got it, she just went the wrong direction. She likes to go to that right. That time they were giving her the left.
That might be something that teams continue to scout with Eastman as she gets more film on her, and she may be forced to go to that left as Nielsen has the ball far side of the court, driving in, hanging for a jumper, missed it off the back of the cup, rebound taken by Stevens, tiptoeing the baseline, but she didn't tiptoe enough as she stepped out.
Oh, Stevens did a nice job getting the rebound against Murphy, and in the battle, Murphy pushed her and gets enough momentum to carry her out of bounds, and that's a turnover.
58 seconds left in the first half. 30 seconds on the shot clock for Garrigan. Capacious faces the bucket. She'll drive in. She'll float over Merrill. She'll hit again.
Oh, thank you very much, Abby Capacious says. They were baiting her, and she took the bait, made the basket.
Abby Capacious looking to score. She has 15 points. Her career high is 20. As on the other end, Stevens gets the shot to bounce off the rim and drop through. Libby Stevens with 8 of the 16 North Union points, and it's 35-16 Bishop Garrigan with 33 seconds left in the half.
I think Garrigan will try to use as much of this half as they can. There's just a few seconds between the shot clock and the game clock, and they're going to try to work it all the way down to the very end.
About a 2.5 second difference as Capacious holds the ball near half court. Shot clock taken down to 15 seconds. Bishop Garrigan up 35-16, and Capacious will continue to hold as Ulrich gives her some space. Now Ulrich creeps up. Capacious hands off to Bartolo near half court. 7 seconds, 6 seconds. The pass out to Montag. Left open for a tray, and it's too long. Rebound for Murphy. Murphy out to Hoagland. Has time, passes it to Bartolo. Back over to Montag. Montag's got to shoot it, and she'll run out of time. Bishop Garrigan had a couple good looks at the end that they passed up, but they will settle for a 35-16 lead at halftime. We'll head to the halftime break. Come back after these messages on KLGA 92.7 and at the Elgato Radio YouTube channel.
High school sports on Hometown and Home Country Radio are brought to you by these fine sports club members.
American Glass. For all your glass needs, think American.
Farm Bureau Financial Agents Dave Beich, Jason Brace, Daniel Folk, and Michael Toth.
Kemco Tires, they're all you need to know about tires and service.
Weikert Realtors, the 515 Agency, a fresh approach to real estate.
Billy Offerman, your State Farm Insurance agent in Algona. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Iowa Lakes Community College, your community, your college.
Lusher Family Dentistry, serving your family since 1965 on Call Street in Algona.
BMC Advantage Insurance Services, insuring our neighbors for over 80 years.
Walker Chiropractic and Wellness, caring for Algona, Sway City, and the surrounding areas with chiropractic, nutritional, and physical therapy services.
All sponsors of this game broadcast.
Time here at North Union High School as the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears right now lead the North Union Warriors by a score of 35-16. Again, the girls game going second today because the North Union boys and girls play tomorrow at the Baumgars Invitational in Sioux City, but the boys play at 10 a.m., the girls play at 1 p.m., so the North Union boys getting a little rest right now. But back to the girls game here, the score at halftime again, 35-16 in favor of Bishop Garrigan. The scoring by quarter looked like this. Bishop Garrigan jumped out to a 21-6 lead at the end of one as North Union didn't get their first bucket until 6 minutes into the ball game, and Bishop Garrigan had a 14-10 scoring advantage in the second quarter. As far as the individual scoring is concerned, Abby Capacious leading the way with 15 points as she approaches her career high of 20. Emmy Bartolo of 9 and Zoe Montag of 8 for the Golden Bears. On the North Union side of things, Libby Stevens with half the points. She has 8. Naomi Jones has 4. Olivia Merrill and Ainsley Orrick of 2 apiece. And that's the big factor. Orrick, the leading scorer for North Union, had held to 2 in the first half. It has been a great night defensively for the Golden Bears. I'll say this again. That interior defense has been so impressive. Defending about fouling. They're not sending North Union to the free throw line. They're forcing all the drivers to go way out wide, make it a tougher shot than it would have been initially if you just attack inside. This is just some really good fundamental play on the interior of the Golden Bear defense.
Well, they're definitely challenging you down low. They're in that 2-3 defense, and as soon as that ball goes inside, they all collapse, and North Union not wanted to kick it out and shoot those 3-point shots, and so they're really battling low. Merrill is very tough, though. She's going to get her points in this game if they keep going inside. She's got a nice repertoire of moves, very strong player, so she'll get some points in there eventually. But that defense for Garrigan has really been their calling card this year. I mean, they've held a couple teams completely scoreless for quarters. And to hold the team for an entire quarter without a bucket is very impressive. And they almost did it tonight against this very good North Union team, as they didn't score until 2 minutes left to go in the first quarter.
Meanwhile, on the offensive side, it seems the past 2 or 3 games, Abby Capacious has really looked to score a lot more. And there's so many aspects to her game, the passing, the rebounding, and the ability to score. But a lot of times, Abby Capacious defers to her teammates because she's an unselfish player and she sees opportunities for others to score. Tonight, she's really cleaning the glass. She's really looking to initiate for herself on offense. And you can see what she can do on the offensive side when she really kind of takes that leading scoring role on a given night.
Yeah, boy, can't say enough about Capacious. I just take her for granted over the years, but you're totally right. Like, she just wants to win. She's just such a selfless player. They have that on their warm-up shirts. It says be selfless, and Abby Capacious is the epitome of that. She's definitely a fantastic leader by example, but she can also be a vocal leader as well. She's always quick to encourage a teammate. I think she's been very good with the freshman Gracelyn Eastman, the post player for the Bears so far this season. And it's really easy to be Sasha Alish, Emmy Bartolo, Zoe Montag, and those 3-point aces from outside when you know you have Capacious likely going to get a rebound if you miss. So, like, she is off the ball, on the ball. Capacious does absolutely everything you ask of her. And Coach Schwab would, I'm sure, echo my comments there. She's a dream to coach. And, Garrigan's going to miss that senior for sure. She wasn't overshadowed by Crooks and Joyce and Ashlyn Holby last year. Like, she was every bit of important to the team last year. But this year, you know, she's really the one. Like, you saw it a second ago. She got that ball alone in the lane, and she's so used to passing up to her teammates. She almost had to be yelled at to shoot that ball, and she did, and she made it. And I think if she wanted to, Abby Capacious could score 20 any night that she wanted. But like you said, Tyler, she's selfless. You know, in fact, the Bears playing selflessly, they didn't get a shot off at the end of the quarter or at the end of the half because they kept passing the ball up, trying to give it to someone else.
Yeah, that was the one example you should say they were maybe a little too selfless because they had a couple good looks at the end of the quarter and they didn't take it. But that's about the only thing you can complain about in the first half for Bishop Garrigan as they lead 35-16 over North Union again. Just big-time start to the game. They've gradually extended their lead since that big start. Right now they're in a great position. And the 3-point shooting, once again, on point. That was one thing last year that helped North Union stay around against Bishop Garrigan in this gym. The Golden Bears had a cold shooting night as far as three-pointers are concerned, and they won 63-49, which for last year's team for Bishop Garrigan was a low margin of victory. victory, and that was a game where North Union played pretty well against Bishop Garrigan. But today, Zoe Montag's knocked down a few three-pointers. Emmy Bartolos hit three of them. I mean, the Golden Bears are a team, they're going to let it fly. They're taking 24 three-pointers a game, and they are so confident to shoot at any time from long range.
Yeah, they can't wait to shoot those three-pointers. In fact, they look to kick that ball outside to the open three-point shooter, and they're very good at finding that open. They run a few little sets. They got Zoe Montag was hot, and so they knew that, and they were able to find her. They look for the person that's hot. Emmy Bartola was hot. They try to find her. Just good team recognition. Know who's got the hot hand, because when you're a three-point shooting team, not everyone's going to be making them. If you have a night where everyone's making the three-pointers, well, good for you. But it's a streaky game, and Garrigan does a good job identifying that. You know, this North Union team, and a lot of teams are going to play Garrigan this year. You know, I know that a lot of people were waiting for Crooks and Joyce and company to graduate and move on and have a better chance against Garrigan. Yeah, a better chance, but Garrigan is still an outstanding team. They still have a lot of great players, and they're going to roll a lot of teams. So, you know, if you're playing Garrigan like your North Union at this point, you're down 19. You got to start, well, what can we do? What can we work on? Because Garrigan is also an excellent team to coach against because, you know, they're short. They don't have a lot of height. Eastman's the tallest player on the floor, and she doesn't have that much height. So North Union, I expect Coach Tigges is going to come out here, Tyler, and he's really going to utilize Merrill. She's a good post player. I think she's going to put up a lot of points this half as Coach Tigges is going to really utilize that inside. He already did. Naomi Jones had some excellent drives inside. But as you said, Tyler, Garrigan, interior defense, better than I expected.
Interior defense has been great so far tonight for Bishop Garrigan as Coach Tigges looks to move the chess pieces around and get Olivia Merrill going in the second half. We are about 3 minutes away from the second half of basketball action. We'll step aside for a couple of final quick messages before that second half begins. It's coming up on KLGA 92.7 and at the Elgona Radio YouTube stream.
We've got more Sports Club members making this broadcast possible on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Reeves Wicked Good Bar and Grill. For wicked good food, drinks, and service, you gotta go to Reeves.
CB Grain Solutions, satisfaction guaranteed.
New Way K&H Co-op, delivering exceptional value through knowledge and innovation.
Dump It, they do the dirty work so you don't have to.
Elbert Electric, flip the switch to Elbert Electric.
Grassmasters, growing satisfied customers.
Greg Penning and Company, certified public accountants, where everyone counts.
Yemlin Builders and Apartments, quality apartments for rent, beauty and craftsmanship that will never go out of style.
Daylight Donuts, open early with delicious donuts and great coffee.
All sponsors of this game broadcast.
At Security State Bank, we focus on the needs of local families, businesses, and farmers. Decisions are made locally. We live and work in your neighborhood, helping to keep our local community vibrant and growing. We're involved in local community events. We believe in personalized service and advice that meets or exceeds your expectations. We're Security State Bank in Elgona, Burt, and Laverne. Bankers who believe in you. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender. Security State Bank.
Thank you to these sports club members bringing you this game on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Kossuth Regional Health Center, make KRHC your home for health care.
Tom Eichen Sales, your store in the country, carrying steel and Toro products and Green Mountain pellet grills.
Elgona Plumbing and Heating, where a good flush always beats a full house.
Runke Brothers Full Service. Experience the Runke Brothers difference for all your auto service and repair needs.
Erpelding Boyd & Company CPAs, they're not just about taxes.
Hy-Vee, use the Fuel Saver card. Fill your cart, fuel your car.
North Iowa Appliance Center, Highway 18 East in Elgona, where they sell the best and service the rest.
Erpelding Excavating Enterprises, let them take care of your grading, excavating, and drainage needs.
AK's Chrome Kitchen. When you come in, your family.
All sponsors of this game broadcast.
start of the second half on Hometown Radio KLGA and the Elgo to Radio YouTube stream. Bishop Garrigan leading North Union right now 35-16 as the Warriors will have the basketball to start the second half. They'll move from right to left on the radio dials. 8 minutes are on the clock, and we are just about set to go. Abby Capacious, the leading scorer among both teams with 15 points so far, as Ainsley Ulrich waits along the stage area far side of the court. She'll inbound the ball to Libby Stevens, and we are rolling in the third quarter. Stevens, North Union's leader for 8 points, finds Merrill immediately, works against Eastman, hits the spin move, ball swirls out of the cup, no good, and the rebound ripped away by Zoe Montag, and a foul on Merrill.
No. A late call against Merrill. She just did a wonderful post move, and that ball went around every part of the rim and out. I don't know how it didn't go down the cylinder. But then she picks up a foul on the rebound.
And that's her third foul. But I'll tell you what, Mr. Crystal Ball, you were just talking about how Coach Tagus really wanted to get the ball inside the Merrill in the second half and give her some opportunities. That was a great opportunity right there that the Warriors just couldn't cash in on.
Yeah, and she got tied up with Montag on the rebound. Almost accidental, but she draws a foul there.
Allish on the right wing, trying to weave past Stevens, finds Montag. Montag left angle three, and she knocks it down. Zoe Montag having a hot shooting night, and it's 38-16 Garrigan.
Yeah, Zoe's got 11 on the night, 3 three-pointers.
Warriors weaving to the front court of Jones. Jones almost ran into Merrill that time. She gives the ball up to Stevens. Stevens splits down the lane. Stevens kicks it out to Jones on the right wing. Jones drives past Capacious. Eastman the help defense. Jones shot no good. Merrill off the board. Power dribble. Back up a foot as she puts it in.
Good move with her left hand. Yeah, she's going to put up some points here if she can keep from getting that fourth foul.
4 points right now for Olivia Merrill as it's 38-18 Bishop Garrigan. Capacious dives down the lane. Challenges Merrill and she floats it over the top for two.
Their 2-3 defense is allowing Abby to get that ball just below the free throw line, and once she gets it there, it's done deal.
Stevens, top of the key, heads right of the lane, picks up her dribbles. Bartolo gets in front of her. Bounce pass back outside to Ainsley Ulrich, who was held to 0 points in the first half. Ulrich tees up a jumper, left it short, and the rebound is taken by Allish for Bishop Garrigan. Allish gets into the front court, heads left of the paint, backs it out to the wing as she picks up her dribble. Capacious now in the high post, kicks it out. Bartolo, rainbow arcing three-point ball, and she cans it! Emmy Bartolo from downtown, and it's 43-18.
Wow, when the three-pointers are going in, it's just bread and butter.
Here comes the full-court press.
Stevens stepped on the line when she went to throw it in.
Yeah, I was about to say, that's a mistake you see the road teams make here, that small out-of-bounds territory, but Stevens just stepped over, and North Union just pressing here in the third.
I guess maybe we should credit the Garrigan cheerleaders with causing that turnover, because she was trying to throw it in right in front of the cheerleaders. No room between the cheerleaders and the line, and Capacious just gets another bucket in that mid-range jump shot.
Capacious just floating it into the lane. She has 19 points, and now the Warriors throw it away in the backcourt. Jones hangs her head down to the floor, and this has been that kind of night for North Union.
Well, Garrigan comes out, hits two threes, one by Montag, one by Bartolo. Capacious gets a couple buckets, and just like that, it balloons up 45-18.
The Warriors have been the runner-up to Garrigan in the conference the past two seasons, getting a crack at
Allish.
Garrigan about Joyce and Crooks is Allish now will step over the line and turn it over on the inbounds play.
I think it's Harper Nelson, the cheerleader down there. She must be pushing the girls onto the floor.
you know, normally the referees would probably say the cheerleader should move over, and they probably should at this point. There's just not enough room down there, for being honest, but both teams get called for one of those, as that we'll say that offsets.
Or just kindly ask the cheerleaders to make a little space.
Stevens sidesteps into a long two of her foot on the line, and the rebound is boxed out by Eastman as she boxes out Merrill. Three-pointer no good for North Union. The Warriors have really struggled to shoot threes outside of Ainsley Ulrich. Bartol tracks down the ball in the backcourt, finds Capacious. Capacious, pass knocked away, goes out to Montag for a three-point try, pops out of the cup, no good, and another offensive board for Capacious. Bishop Garrigan had a big rebounding edge last season, 42-17 and 39-18 in the two games these teams matched up, and that's been the case again tonight. Bartolo skips in, finds Eastman, clangs it up the side of the rim, no good. Merrill rips the rebound away, and a foul on Eastman as Bartolo nearly had a highlight reel assist.
Eastman frustrated. Capacious picks her right up. Eastman is only frustrated because Bartolo put such a nifty move in to create that assist, and I know Eastman wanted to get that bucket.
Merrill gives the ball off to Libby Stevens. But outside of Ainsley Ulrich, the Warriors are 11 of 61 on three-pointers this season. That's an 18% rate. And so far tonight, they really have avoided taking the three for the most part. Stevens Bounce pass to Orlick, deep on the wing. She'll launch from three-point range, and it's an air ball heading out of bounds, and it'll go back to Garrigan.
Oh, both teams wanting to shoot that three-point shot. You know, Tyler, the kids these days, they love the three-point shot. You can see all the student section on both teams when a three-point ball goes up. They all get excited. They want to see that big splash. But, you know, I like drives to the basket, and if it's a boys' game, unless we see any girls dunk it, I want to see some throwdowns. I want to see some dunks this season.
Oh, man, if there's one thing the crowd loves more than three-point balls, it's dunks. Of course, on the boys' side, Michael Joyce had a big-time flush against Belmont Clemmy back at the beginning part of the season for the Golden Bears. We may see a couple of the boys' players dunk throughout the season on the Golden Bears' side of things, as right now the girls have a 45-18 lead over North Union. Aulish throws it into the backcourt. Bartolo able to chase it down. She'll flip it up ahead to Aulish. Finds the patience on the baseline. Quick pass inside Eastman. Misses the layup. Got her own miss, and she sets it in. 47-18, Bishop Garrigan. That's 5 points for Grayson Eastman. And 4:26 left in the third quarter as Stevens heads towards the front court. Stevens, top of the key, heads left of the paint. Flips it out to Walters, who just checked into the ball game. Walters and Ulrich, the two freshmen, getting regular minutes for North Union. As Jones heads towards the right, guarded by Capacious. Into Merrill. Merrill turns around. Merrill spinning 360, shoots over Eastman. Ball rolls off, no good. And there's a lid on that side of bucket two. Into the front court, Montag finding Bartolo. Deep contested three-pointer. Clangs up the glass, no good. Eastman on the cleanup, and she puts it in.
Good rebound by Eastman, and then Coach Schwab wants to get a timeout. I think he just wants to talk about how they've been doing. I've been sleeping on the job and forgot to note that they switched to a man-to-man defense, and I think Coach Schwab just wants to call timeout and assess how this defense is going. I mean, at this point, up 49-18. Both coaches are just trying to work on improving their game, and that's what they're talking about right now. Good play there by Eastman down low on that rebound there, and she stuck with one that she missed a second ago as she continues to come along.
I think tonight you're seeing some of the fundamental issues for North Union start to creep in, because they're a team that's always so consistent. You can count on them to be a top two or three team in the conference, but some of the things that have bothered them in the past are bothering them again tonight. Lower percentages on three-point shooting, not much scoring off the bench. In fact, coming into tonight, they didn't have anyone who'd scored more than 8 points off the bench this season, so kind of rounding out that depth and finding their jump shot are two areas that are a little weak right now for the Warriors. The good news for them is normally on a nightly basis, they are a very good defensive team, but Garrigan's just having a great shooting night. They're getting great creation from Abby Capacious, and that's been the way they picked apart a tough North Union defense in this game.
Absolutely. And Garrigan sticking with their man-to-man here. Regardless of what they've tried defensively tonight, it has really been successful. Libby Stevens, excellent guard, has had a hard time getting anything going.
So Stevens has the rock right now. Scored 8 points in the first half, yet to score in the second half for North Union. Walters sets the screen. Aulish goes over the top of it. Now Stevens switches back towards the right side. Stevens wants to drive. Stevens floats it up, and she left the layup short. Got her on miss, trying to stay away from contact, and looks like Aulish got her on the wrist for a Bishop Garrigan foul.
So, you know, we look at that possession right there. Stevens had that ball that entire North Union possession, eventually found her way to the basket, but still good interior defense as Reese Kemp is going to check in for Zoe Montag, who's had a hot hand here since the very about 2 minutes in the game, she started to heat up. She missed her first couple, and since then, she's been lights out.
Speaking of three-pointers, Kemna, someone who will come in and shoot the three, is Orlick foul line jumper, and she got fouled by Emmy Bartolo. But Kemna comes in having attempted 10 shots this season, all of which have come from three-point range, as Orlick's going to set up for two free throws.
Emmy Bartolo chuckling over as she comes to have a chat with Coach Schwab. You know, she left her feet and went for that block. You know, Emmy Bartolo is so used to playing the top of a 2-3 defense. When they switch to man, it's such a different challenge for them.
Orlick misses on the first free throw. She left it short. Ainsley Orlick this year has attempted 55 three-pointers. The rest of North Union just 49 is offensive board by Merrill off the missed free throw. And pass knocked away by Bartolo. She stepped out of bounds. The Warriors will keep it. But in addition to that, Orlick has made 16 three-pointers. The rest of the team just 11. So they're not getting a ton of long-range shooting outside of Orlick.
Here's a good scoring opportunity for North Union. Out-of-bounds plays. If they execute it, they'll get a score.
Garrigan, their 2-3 inbound defense. Into the lane, Walters flings it out to the wing to Naomi Jones. Jones across the foul line. Jones driving in. Floats the right-hander up. No good. And Capacious snatches another rebound. Here comes Abby Capacious. Finds Stacia Aulish on the perimeter. Aulish driving in. Her pass knocked away. And Merrill has the steal for North Union.
Here comes Steven. Steven and Jones, they keep getting to the basket, but they just can't get that ball to drop.
Now on the wing, it's Orlick with 3 minutes left in quarter number three at a 49-18 Garrigan lead. Orlick dribbles it off her leg, and a turnover forced as Bartolo has the basketball for Bishop Garrigan. Bartolo down to our right. She's on the wing with 2:48 on the clock. Capacious at the elbow. Surveying. Now Capacious drives. She floats it up again, and she puts it in. That is the career high for Abby Capacious. Her previous was 20 back on January 18th of 2022, and an 80-33 win over Lake Mills. She has 21 tonight. Driving left, Stevens, and she'll set it in for two.
There, Stevens gets to the backhand and lays it in. Bucket lays it in with her left hand. Good to see. Here's Olish with a deep
Olish
three.
Olish trying to get on track with a three-pointer. Left it short. Olish trying to track down the rebound, but it's off her hand and goes to Zoe Montag for Bishop Garrigan. Golden Bears averaging 33.5 rebounds per game this season. They're having a good rebounding night tonight as we're down to the final 2:11 in this one of the third quarter. Driving right, Bartolo trying to get past Ulrich, forcing her to the baseline. She fouled Bartolo, and Bartolo put it in.
Wow, what a drive by Bartolo. She is all smiles. Happy camper Emmy Bartolo. She has been shooting threes, lights out, drive to the basket there. It's always nice, Tyler. You can't take it for granted. Sometimes sports is so stressful, you never get to see these kids have any fun. They look so serious all the time. Seeing some smiles out there tonight. Bartolo flashing a big grin after that good move.
This is a very fun night if you're a Bishop Garrigan fan right now, as the second free throw no good by Bartolo, and ball out of bounds off the hands of Capacious as Dorfman gets it back up. We're down 53-20.
Coach Swab putting up the five fingers, wants to stick with man-to-man. Reagan Murphy into the game. She's an excellent defender here. Montag's guarding Merrill. That's a tough challenge.
Merrill out high as Stevens has the basketball. Stevens goes around Merrill, 1:56 left. Jones in left quarter underneath to Walters. Walters had a brief moment to shoot it, but couldn't get the shot off, and she got it back out to Jones. Out to Stevens with 1:48 on the clock in quarter number three. Lobs to Merrill, top of the key. Gives it off to Ulrich, deep three-pointer, and it rims out no good as Capacious picks up another rebound. Abby Capacious guns it underneath to Murphy, and it's out of her reach.
Yeah, if Capacious would have been a quarterback had she gone out for the football team her whole career. She's got a cannon. That time she throws it a little too hard. She's going to come out of the game, get a break. Big round of applause for Abby Capacious as Gracelyn Eastman takes her place. Reagan Murphy is the one guarding Olivia Merrill. Or no, yeah. Nope, Reagan's on Naomi Jones. So that goes back to our 6-on-6 argument, Tyler. If Garrigan was a 6-on-6 team, I think they can find three dynamite guards out there, Murphy being one of them.
Stevens' right-angle three-pointer missed it. Nielsen tried to sail in for the rebound. It's off her hands, and it'll be last touched by Garrigan. All right, Beanie, let's get your take on air right now.
For me, all right.
Or 6-on-6, what's your lineup for
six
Garrigan?
6-on-6, well, the defenders, I'm going to go with Murphy. I think as good as Olish is, I might want to put her on defense because she's so tenacious. And then, well, Montag maybe?
In the lane, it's Jones. Jones shot blocked,
nice,
and a foul.
Nice strip by Montag there. That was a good strip, but too much contact at the foul. But offense for Garrigan, 6-on-6. Boy, you got maybe Capacious would be a good defender. She'd certainly get plenty of those rebounds.
That's what I was thinking, too. Capacious is the hardest decision because she'd do really well on offense and defense in the 6-on-6 game and our normal 5-on-5 game as well. So, yeah, to put her between offense and defense is really a tough call.
Well, then offense, you got Bartolo splashing threes and Eastman inside. And, this would be a good, solid 6-on-6 team. But we're not turning back the clock yet, Tyler. That's for sure.
Yeah, we have not yet invented the time machine to figure that out, as it's 53-22 in favor of Garrigan. Both free throws good for Jones for North Union. 1:04 left in the third quarter as Olish gives it off to Montag. Montag working for 11 points. Montag wants to drive in, and she carried the basketball for a turnover.
She did a little hesitation move, and the referee did not like that. Calls the scoop, held ball, whatever you want to call it. Here comes Stevens and Jones, who are definitely wearing the frustration on their face. So they've been held below their season totals tonight.
Ulrich outside for a three-point ball, left it way short. Rebound to Jones, and Jones puts it in for two.
Good bucket by Jones there. Good rebound. Johnny on the spot. 53-24. Here comes Olish.
8 points by Jones, 10 by Stevens for North Union. Reese Kemna handles the rock for Garrigan. Gets it into Eastman. Keeps it away from Nielsen. Eastman uses the pivot foot. Gets it back out to Olish. Stevens tipped it into the backcourt as Olish flags it down. 25 seconds on the game clock. 17 on the shot clock as we wind down the third quarter. Olish will dribble the ball near half court. Surveyed by Stevens as she passes left to Montag. Montag holds the ball high and away from Ulrich. Guns it underneath to Eastman. Eastman heads right. Flings it to Kemna. And we're going to have a three-second violation called against Garrigan.
Yeah, Eastman was flirting with that three-second call. She got out of the lane the first time she had the ball just in the nick of time. But that clued the referee in to keep an eye on it. and then gets called for 3 seconds the next time she goes back in.
8 seconds left for North Union as Jones has the ball, gives to Nielsen of 6 seconds. Nielsen out to Stevens, has to create a three. Stevens drives of two, floats of one, and she knocks it down. Right before the end of the quarter, Libby Stevens hits, and that'll make it a 53-26 ball game as we head to quarter number four. 60-second timeout, and back after this on KLGA 92.7 and the Elgwater Radio YouTube stream.
For over 40 years, Northwest Iowa Bone, Joint, and Sports Surgeons have maintained one mission: to provide excellence in orthopedic care. Their team of 9 physicians offer specialized care in everything from arthroscopic same-day surgery to joint replacement, as well as hand and foot surgery, and have an orthopedic surgeon on call 24/7. Healthcare isn't about appointments, it's about taking care of people, and that's their specialty. Visit Northwest Iowa Bone, Joint, and Sports Surgeons on the web at nwiabone.com.
When you need cash on the go, there's no need to pay a surcharge fee with MoneyPass. Iowa State Bank is proud to be part of the MoneyPass network of surcharge-free ATMs found nationwide. Look for the green and blue MoneyPass symbol on over 32,000 ATMs across the nation. Or find an ATM near your vacation spot or travel destination at MoneyPass.com. MoneyPass, another way that Iowa State Bank helps people succeed. Member FDIC.
Start of the fourth quarter right now on Hometown Radio KLGA. Bishop Garrigan has the basketball, beating North Union 53-26 in this girls' matchup. Golden Bears have it. They find Capacious underneath. Capacious working against Nielsen. Feeds it to the cutting Eastman. Back outside, Zoe Montag, right angle three-pointer, and misses off to the right. Ball goes over the backboards and out of bounds. Well, Beanie, the Golden Bears have frozen out North Union tonight on this unseasonably warm night as we head into the Christmas season. Are we going to get any snow before Christmas? What say you?
I say we're going to get just enough to make people feel like, all right, we had a smattering of snow, but it won't stick around. But we're expect some flurries before Christmas, at least, just to get you in the mood.
All right. There you go, folks. Mark it down. Say it's official, 100% certainty. That's the beanie weather forecast. As Stevens drives in, Stevens on the blow by puts it in for two.
Well,
it's 53,
look at
28.
That. Last two times North Union has had the ball, Stevens, great drive to the hoop. Maybe just a little tense this whole contest because now it seems easy for her.
Golden Bears had an 18-10 scoring edge during quarter number three. They lead at 53-28 right now as Emmy Bartolo has it up top. Bartolo, 14 points tonight, finds Sasha Aulish. Golden Bears having a good offensive night with Aulish only having 7 points so far. Capacious lobs to Eastman, takes one dribble, works right around Steinberger, and Eastman puts it in.
That is the rehearsed move. She's very good at that move. Can make it at that angle towards the basket. Garrigan sticking into man-to-man defense.
55-28, Bishop Garrigan as North Union has the rock right now. Bounce pass goes near side to Jones. Jones across the lane, spins, pivots, puts it up through traffic, rolls off to the right, and Capacious has yet another rebound. This has to be about 21 points and 15 rebounds. I haven't been tracking rebounds for Capacious, but 15 would be my guesstimate. Is Bartolo no good on a three? Eastman offensive board, scoops up a wild layup, no good. Capacious rebound again, and Capacious draws a foul of 6:22 left.
Well, we can safely say she's got a double-double with that rebound. There's no way she's still got single-digit rebounds, and we know she's got double-digit points with 21 here on the board.
I mean, would it be crazy to say, I mean, she'll probably check out before she can get to this, but 2020 might not be too far away for Capacious, who already has 21 points. The jump shot free throw sits on the back of the iron and drops in to make it 56-28.
Boy, that's quite an accomplishment. 20 points, 20 rebounds. I mean, this is not the NBA. This is just high school four-quarter basketball. That would be something if Abby can pull that off.
That's something you saw a couple of times from Audie Crooks and not really from anyone else, and for good reason, because of how hard it is to do. So we'll see what the official box score is tomorrow, as right now Bishop Garrigan leads 56-28. Heading to the right is Ulrich. Bartolo trying to rake at that ball. Bartolo pokes it out, and Bartolo has the steal. The defense has been ferocious all night for Bishop Garrigan. Gets it up ahead to Montag with 6:04 left. As Montag gets it across to Aulish. Down to 6 minutes left in this game. Now Capacious with 22 points. Bartolo 14. 11 on the board for Montag tonight is 5:52 left in this one. Golden Bears have the crosstown game against Algona tomorrow. Tipping off at 2:30 is Bartolo. Make that Montag goes in and she scoops up the layup for two.
Pretty scoop layup with the left hand by Montag. Here comes Stevens looking to drive.
On the other end, Stevens with 5:37 left. Dumps it inside to Merrill. Knocked away by Capacious, but a foul. Golden Bears done a good job avoiding fouls today, but that'll be team foul number two, or make that number one of this quarter.
Yeah, and after North Union picked up five fouls in the first quarter pretty quickly, this second half has been entirely foul-free. Only three fouls on each team here in the fourth.
I will say, comparing the girls' game to the boys' game, as Stevens flips it up and misses, rebound Montag, the girls tonight have done a much better job adjusting to the officials than the boys. The game number one was a travel fest and had a lot of fouls, but the girls have figured out what the referees are going to call and adjusted to it as Alish knocks down a free from the far side.
Yeah, Alish has had several 20-point games. She doesn't have to score points when her teammates are scoring. Another selfless attitude. Capacious
Believe
with a nifty
not,
steal.
That's Alish's first points of the night. I wrongly gave her 7 points earlier. Those are Eastman's points, as Eastman's now up to nine. Alish with her first three. So Garrigan above the 60-point mark with their leading scorer having just 3 points. Or leading scorer from earlier this season, I should say, as we're under 5 minutes left. Alish right of the lane. Shot rejected by Merrill. That was an emphatic stuff. And some frustration taken out on that ball as well.
Yeah, big block by Merrill. She's going to score a lot of points this season, I think. North Union, another good team to follow in our area, Tyler. Boy, so many good teams in our listening area to follow this season.
Ball knocked out of bounds, and it will stay with Bishop Garrigan. Well, the top of Iowa West is interesting. Bishop Garrigan and Forest City both came into tonight 4-0 in conference play. North Union and Lake Mills were both 3-1. Everyone else 2 or 3 or worse. So the top four teams seem to have separated. And I think based on the results for Garrigan so far, Forest City and Garrigan seem to be 1A and 1B in whatever order you want to put them in, as Montag sails in for two. North Union and Lake Mills seem to be at next group down right now, unless they make a big improvement in the second half. But that's the fun thing. Both teams will see each other again, and it could be an entirely different game when these teams match up next time around. As Orwick works the baseline, Orwick reverses, and missed on that layup. Tough shot by Orwick, and Capacious once again jawing on the spot for a rebound. 63-28 Garrigan. Montag from way downtown. Missed it off to the right. Eastman had the rebound briefly, but deflects over to Jones. Well, Beanie, I'm not sure if we'll have time for this tomorrow, so I'm going to ask you right now to go on the record. What is your favorite Christmas movie?
Oh, wow, Tyler. I didn't see that coming. You got to give me a little advance notice
That's right.
on that.
Think but, about it while
okay,
this possession goes
no,
on.
I'll go classic. I love It's a Wonderful Life. I'm an old nostalgic. Love it. But White Christmas has come into play recent years. See, this is a hard question. But, of course, for pure comedy, you got to go National Lampoon's Christmas Vacation. So, sentimental, Jimmy Stewart, comedy, Chevy Chase. You can't go wrong.
You can't go wrong. All right, that's a good list there, Beanie. So I will, I don't know if it's the best or not, but I always find myself watching Elf at least once during Christmas season. I still think that movie is funny, even though maybe it's not as funny as it used to be, but Elf is a good one.
Well, the question
is,
Tyler, in the movie Elf, which character do you most identify? Are you Buddy? Are you identify as Buddy? Is that, who you are?
That's too existential of a question for me to answer in this broadcast. As Garrigan has entered in the substitutions, Nemers misses on a layup, but as a Cleveland native,
well,
you've also got to throw in A Christmas Story as well, because the Christmas Story house, of course, located in the Cleveland area.
Well, you're definitely Ralphie if you're in that movie. You're definitely a Ralphie type.
I'm not even going to argue with that, as Jones tees up a jump shot and knocks it down to make it 63-30. Subs are coming in as well for North Union. Jones is going to end tonight with 8 points. For Garrigan on the floor right now, Regan Murphy, Alyssa Hoagland, Reese Kemna, Haley Nemers, and Elena Casey. We'll get you North Union here in a second as Garrigan brings it across half court. But the North Union Warriors are going to have Alexis Cummins on the floor. Alyssa Welbig as the ball goes out of bounds.
Alyssa Hoagland just tried to thread the needle, went off one of the North Union players. We were able to catch a lot of the JV girls game. Normally, we don't always get to see that because of the different order tonight. We got to catch some JV girls, and they had a really exciting contest.
Three-point ball, Hoagland left it short. Also in the game, Alyssa Welbig, Avery Wallstead for North Union. And Jennifer Carranza as well, rounding out the Warrior Five for the final 2:30 in this one. 63-30, Bishop Garrigan, Elena Casey with the basketball right now for the Golden Bears. Members trying to create post position inside as Hoagland has it up top. Golden Bears going for their 10th straight win over North Union as kick out to Casey. Three-point ball on the way. Just missed that one. That would have gone the loudest cheer of the night for Garrigan if that ball had gone down.
They would have ever wanted the senior Elena Casey to get a bucket there.
North Union with the ball of 2:05 left. Well, Beanie, obviously for Garrigan, a couple games of four-winner break as the Warriors have it with 2 minutes left. Working towards the right is Cummins. The Golden Bears will have the crosstown game on Saturday as the three-point ball misses by Welbig. Tracked down will be by Cummins and a foul by Garrigan. But crosstown game Saturday, North Iowa Tuesday, then Christmas break. Then coming out of the break, Forest City against Bishop Garrigan. Both teams could possibly still be undefeated in conference play at that time.
Well, I hope we're broadcasting that game. That sounds like an exciting one for me to be at.
We'll be live in Forest City, Iowa.
Good, because
be there or be square, folks.
You know, Tyler, I don't go to the games unless you're here.
Well, I appreciate that as the shot misses by North Union, and Roffler grabs the rebound for Bishop Garrigan.
We'll see if they can get Elena Casey the ball again. Her parents are to my right, ready to explode when she scores.
Nemers in the post instead, trying to drive her way in, and a jump ball. Jump ball, the possession arrow in favor of North Union.
Oh, they called the jump there. Nemers might have got away with the travel there. Well, when these girls that are on the floor right now, they just played 2 hours ago in the JV game, basically the same lineups. North Union got out to a big lead, double-digit lead, and Garrigan slowly crawled back the whole game and got him in the end. But this could be a good matchup in the future.
Jumper on the way by Wallstead misses. It heads out of bounds, and Garrigan gets it back with 52 seconds left. It shouldn't technically be a running clock, but they're operating it like it's a running clock, even though it's only a 33-point game. But I don't think anyone's going to argue at this point.
I guess not.
They've let the clock run as Kemna heads towards the right. Giving it off to Hoagland, 37 seconds left. Hoagland drives left of the lane. Hoagland floats it up, and she banks it in. Now it's a running clock. 29 seconds left. 65 to 30, Bishop Garrigan. Cummins gets the ball over to the right. Three-point ball, Bierstead on the way, left and short. Rebounded in the lane by Wallstead. Wallstead's follow no good, and Nemers grabs the loose basketball for the rebound and gets it off to Roffler. Well, Bishop Garrigan going to pick up the sweep in a tough gymnasium to play in. The boys won, and the girls are going to win dominantly, 65 to 30. The final score on this one is the final 5 seconds tick away, and Bishop Garrigan still undefeated in top of Iowa West play as the final buzzer sounds. Win number 61 in a row in the conference, and it comes in huge fashion, 65 to 30 on the road over the North Union Warriors. We'll step aside for a timeout, wrap it up after this on KLGA 92.7 and at the Elgona Radio YouTube channel.
High school sports on Hometown and Home Country Radio are brought to you by these fine sports club members.
Farmer State Bank is proud to be part of our community. Offices in Elgona, Whittemore, and West Bend.
Stroman Dental, giving you something to smile about.
Bill's Auto and Truck Repair. Service is the difference.
Trend Salon, your complete family hair salon. It's all about you.
Oakcrest Funeral Services, celebrating a life lived.
Algona Frame and Auto Body, we meet by accident.
Water Connection, from softeners to bottled water and service, call 295-SOFT.
Algona Pizza Ranch, there's so much to love.
Cotton Grave Farm Management and Land Realty in downtown Elgona. Trusted for farmland service needs since 1960.
Sponsoring this broadcast on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
At Security State Bank, we focus on the needs of local families, businesses, and farmers. Decisions are made locally. We live and work in your neighborhood, helping to keep our local community vibrant and growing. We're involved in local community events. We believe in personalized service and advice that meets or exceeds your expectations. We're Security State Bank in Elgona, Burt, and Laverne. Bankers who believe in you. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender. Security State Bank.
High school sports on Hometown and Home Country Radio are brought to you by these fine sports club members.
American Glass. For all your glass needs, think American.
Farm Bureau Financial Agents Dave Beisch, Jason Brace, Daniel Folk, and Michael Toth.
Kemco Tires. They're all you need to know about tires and service.
Weikert Realtors, the 515 Agency. A fresh approach to real estate.
Billy Offerman, your State Farm Insurance Agent in Elgona. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Iowa Lakes Community College, your community, your college.
Lusher Family Dentistry, serving your family since 1965 on Call Street in Elgona.
BMC Advantage Insurance Services, insuring our neighbors for over 80 years.
Walker Chiropractic and Wellness, caring for Elgona, Sway City, and the surrounding areas with chiropractic, nutritional, and physical therapy services.
All sponsors of this game broadcast.
Final score, Bishop Garrigan 65, North Union 30, as the Golden Bears now have 61 straight top of Iowa West wins, and they beat the North Union Warriors 10 times in a row, dating back to December 14th of 2018. I'm Tyler Lance, Beanie Buildings and my partners. We wrap this one up. The scoring by quarter went like this. Bishop Garrigan roared out of the gates. They never trailed in this game as they led 21-6 at the end of one. North Union did not score their first bucket until 6 minutes into the ball game. After that, the Golden Bears had a 14-10 scoring advantage in the second quarter as they led 35-16 at halftime. It was 18-10 Golden Bears in the third. third, extending that lead to 53-26 going into the fourth, and a 12-4 advantage in the final stands up by the Golden Bears. Individual leaders were Abby Capacious with a career high of 22 points. Zoe Montag and Emmy Bartolo both chipped in 14, and I believe Gracelyn Eastman had double digits as well, but they took her off the scoreboard before I could see it. As far as North Union goes, Libby Stevens had 14, Naomi Jones 10, and that was really about it as far as double-digit scores for the Warriors. Beanie, I'll start with the defense tonight. We started talking about the boys' postgame with defense. We'll start with the girls' postgame with defense as well. Holding North Union to 30 was a great performance tonight. They held North Union to single digits in both the first quarter and the last quarter, and we said it all night long. Interior defense, just fantastic against a Warrior team that has a good post weapon with Olivia Merrill and players who are good about driving the ball in as well.
Yeah, Garrigan, definitely physical inside. Players are coming out of the locker rooms, meeting with families. Everything seems happy-go-lucky here because both teams have a long ways to go in this season. But, boy, yeah, you're right, Tyler. This interior defense for Garrigan is a big surprise for me. I knew they were going to be loaded with guard talent this year. I knew Gracelyn Eastman was going to be a solid post player. Haley Nemers comes in, solid post player. But I did not realize how good the guards were going to be at adjusting to their interior defense without Audie in there. They've really learned how to work together and kind of have interior defense by committee. They collapse that 2-3 zone, and if you get the ball inside against Garrigan, you're going to have a swarm of players around you in a heartbeat, and they're not afraid to make some contact.
And not only was the defense good tonight, but the offense good as well. Bishop Garrigan came in averaging just under 65 points per game. They scored 65 tonight, and they did it with only 3 points by Sasha Allish. But that's because when one three-point shooter is cold, the others are hot. Emmy Bartolo and Zoe Montag both had great shooting nights. Alyssa Hoagland knocked down a three-pointer. And then you got the mid-range game of Abby Capacious. The old-school mid-range game is still alive.
Yeah, it's fun watching Abby Capacious get that ball in the middle of the lane because you know something good's going to happen. She's either going to put up that little mid-range jump shot, or if they guard her, she's going to find someone down low or even kick it out for a three-pointer. And along that lines of those three-point shooters, Tyler, this is one thing that the Garrigan girls do really well is that they forget their misses really well. You know, it's hard in basketball, especially in a tight gym. If you launch a three-pointer and miss it badly, air ball it, or even if you just barely miss it, you know, it's hard to have the guts to take another shot. And Garrigan forgets their misses immediately. They can miss a couple three-pointers. Like, great example, Zoe Montag tonight, she missed her first two three-pointers in front of the student section over there. Didn't faze her one bit. The next thing you know, she makes their next two, makes another one, 9 points on the board just like that. Emmy Bartolo, same thing. Like, Sasha Alish, she's had big scoring nights here. Tonight, she was more of a distributor. And she had no problem sinking a three-pointer in the second half. It just comes at you from every guard on Garrigan's team. They can all shoot, and you can't guard everybody. And that's the strength of this team. They always have five scorers on the floor at all times.
No doubt about it. Well, big stuff coming up tomorrow. Sleep quickly if you're a North Union fan because they are going all the way over to Sioux Center for the Bombgars Invitational. The boys play at 10 o'clock in the morning. The girls play at 1 o'clock in the afternoon as the girls will face Western Christian, a team that Garrigan saw earlier this season. Meanwhile, for Garrigan, a titanic matchup coming up tomorrow against Algona, especially on the girls' side. You're talking about a Bishop Garrigan team that is ranked number 8 in Class 1A and an Algona team that's ranked number 10 in Class 3A. So we're excited for both games, obviously, but I think on paper, that girls' game should be a colossal struggle between those two teams for crosstown supremacy.
Yeah, it's going to be fun, and every game is different. We saw in the boys' game tonight, it was kind of a matchup difference between the very tall Garrigan team against the very well-meshed North Union boys. Girls' game, you never know how that matchup's going to go, guards versus guards. But tomorrow, such a strange matchup for Garrigan against Algona because Algona's got some height. Garrigan's got some guards. Algona's got a good ball handler. Like, it's a really interesting matchup between these two teams. They played in the summer leagues a couple times. I know both games were really close, so they're very evenly matched teams in the off season. So much stuff goes on in the off season these days, Tyler. But when you put the coaches in the mix, the game changes dramatically. So it'll be interesting to see tomorrow in a formal atmosphere, not summer league. Varsity contest between Algona and Garrigan girls, I think it's going to be an exciting one.
Well, there's no off-season for us, ladies and gentlemen. Turn on the YouTube stream, catch the game. The tip-off is at 2:30 and the pregame is at 2:15. You can also tune in tomorrow morning on 9:05 here at KLGA 92.7 and get the thoughts from the Algona and Bishop Garrigan coaches on our Breakfast with the Coaches program. So that'll be coming up tomorrow morning. And again, Crosstown Basketball here on the radio and on our YouTube stream tomorrow afternoon. That will wrap us up for tonight. For my partner, Beanie Bodie, I'm Tyler Lance signing off as this has been a sports production of Hometown Radio KLGA. Once again, final score, Bishop Garrigan 65 and North Union 30.